5 billion people watching at the moment. How it is going to work is, so we'll go over to the schedule here. So the G1 900 will be taking place across 7 weeks of Nitro Hour 1 and worldwide. Block B, which is why I had Foster read it, read that first. Block B will be on Nitro. I will announce the three matches in just a second. Block A will be over here on Worldwide. Do not worry. Hardcore Thunder will still be a thing.
Oh, thank
God. Week in and week out. That is untouched. The only thing we're going to do, the only rule with Hardcore Thunder, since we have the fans picking the, the viewers rather, picking the people participating in it, I'm just going to ask that the 14 guys in the G1 900 not be picked. That's just to kind of get some variety. We're going to see these guys a lot. We don't want to see them on a third show.
Exactly.
So basically going through the calendar here, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. During there we'll have our pay-per-view. 6, 7, and the finals will be at what is listed as Hell in a Cell. Don't you worry, that won't be the case. It'll be another show right there. Where the
probably
G1...
probably with the word Clash in there somewhere.
Likely with the word Clash, because I probably don't have the arena. So that's how that's going to work. Oh, God, we're not going to have... Get the Clamps is going to ask, are we going to have those tag team matches in between, like the real ones? No, because... I got to be honest, those are kind of boring and all the exact same friggin' thing, so I don't really care to see them. No, we're not going to have the tag matches. However, when we go to a show, since there's four matches per show and there's only three per show for the G1 900, we're going to keep the... If there's a remarkable match, we're going to keep that. If there is two, we're going to get rid of one of them. But so basically, in this case, Malibu Mang... You wanted our tag match? Here you go. Malibu Mang and Bobby Eaton taking on Johnny B. Bad and Evan Courageous.
Oh, wow.
Despite the fact that Evan Courageous will be wrestling in... Oh, you know what? No, you know what? I'm gonna pull the bye week where Evan Courageous is on a bye week and use that one. That's how we're going to solve that, because Evan Courageous... Everyone does have a bye week because there's seven. So let me find which one Evan Courageous is not wrestling on and make a quick adjustment at the last minute, because this is what happens when you let the game do things for you. Okay, so we're going to find out what he wrestles on 6, 5, and 2. Okay, so we're going to make that number 3 then. All right. Excellent. So that means that our opening match will be this tag team match that has screwed up everything already.
Sorry.
That is... No, I expect this game to screw up everything. Do not worry. This won't be the only one. Okay, and let me make sure I got... Okay, perfect. So, what's going to happen is our first match will, in fact, be this tag team match.
I can't look at Malibu Mang.
Why can't you?
It's so ridiculous.
Why can't you? Well, let's just get these going. Let's just get things going with this tag match that is thankfully not done too much to mess anything up. I can tell you right now that our three matches following will be Block B. Bobby Eaton and Malibu Mang just had a war and now they're teaming up. Because of course they are.
They've earned each other's respect.
Sure, let's go with that. Malibu Mang, by the way, the TV champion after Clash Wild. So Block B matches today will be Jerry Flynn taking on Better Call Damien. Yes, that is opening up the G1 900.
Jolly.
Followed by Steve Mongo McMichael taking on Lash LaRue, and our main event for Block B Night 1, Wrath versus the Hollywood Barbarian. I can tell you that the opening contest for Block A will be the Renegade taking on the Disco Inferno, followed by Tom Zenk versus Cancer, the formerly known Prince Iakea. And BK Wall Street will face Bobby Eaton in the main event of Block A Night 1. Woo! Didn't even start the tournament, and it's already screwed it up for me. I love it. So I'm gonna have to go in. I'm actually gonna make an edit. I don't know if you guys noticed, probably not, because I don't really, use the... It's only recent that I've had a page for it. But the WCW Universe mode now has a Wikia page on irmstream.wikia.com. And I'm killing time because this is still going on with this damn... with the damn...
take our production seriously.
Yes, this is the greatest night in the history of our sport. That's basically what's happening. And here comes Johnny B. Bad with no music.
You don't want to make him mad. He is pretty as a picture and looks just like Little Richard. I got this, Brian.
We got spoken word here from Matt Foster. From the professor Matt Foster. Tonight.
Mean left hook. If you don't want to end up sad, don't mess with Johnny B. Bad. He's so pretty.
I will do no such thing. Okay, that is good. Done and done. By the way, I should go ahead and introduce all the people who are here because it's just been so... Yeah. So, we've got me here for you. I guess I'm your Tony Schiavone for the evening because I'm the one who's going to be exasperated by the end of the night. I already am.
Good job, Schiavone.
Yes, Schiavone. We've got the Professor Matt Fostenay.
I'll allow it.
We've got... Wait, Kyle was Zabisco. He's not here.
Kyle
was
Zabisco, yes.
Did we assign someone to you? Blake, did we assign someone to you?
I don't know.
Is there anyone you want to be? I miss what you said.
I don't know. That's not really a great question to ask me.
Okay.
You got Chris Cruz, Brian.
Oh, God, you're Chris Cruz?
No, I'm the guy that was always on the road on the hotline.
Oh, Stagger Blake Marshall. I like it.
There we go.
And we've got Will, Mean Will? We don't have anyone that rhymes with Gene, so we can't have Mean Gene. Will, you got
Chill Will.
Chill Will? Will, do you have a preference?
No, don't even finish that, no. It's not my preference.
It's
no sane man or woman. Fucking nins are a piece of shit.
Will, do you have a preference of who you'd like to be?
God, Hudson.
Are you our Mark Ned?
Shut up, no. Don't even fucking joke about that.
Oh, I didn't even hear Foster say that.
He's not Mark Ned, he's a little wet.
Wet?
Oh, no.
You
Scott
don't
Hudson. I don't care if it doesn't rhyme,
Blake. Oh, Will Hudson. Okay, we got Will Hudson here. And he's pretty quiet, but he's free to chime in whenever you'd like. Everyone's favorite, really, he's more Schiavone than I am when he's in the chat. NTQ is here because he made a debut at the 24-hour stream. Out of all the stuff that happened in those last, 6 hours, it kind of got lost in it that, wait, what? Is this some gamesmanship? Malibu Ming has usurped the three-count music.
Oh, man. Oh, no. He's done it again.
Can we call the faces of three tonight? We'll party up forever.
Why is this happening?
By the way, my prediction for the T1900. Oh wait, Roblox out the turn, right?
Playing it. That's true. Yeah. Okay. That's right. Yeah, that's right. It's like the G1. So we gotta over and analyze it. I need one of you guys to just constantly go hi.
No.
Yeah, interesting thing. Roadblock is not in the G1900 as he was originally announced for it. We'll go ahead with Stagger Blake. Interesting. Is that interesting to you that Bobby Eaton is now replacing Roadblock in Block A?
As much as I dislike Roadblock, I'm wondering what exactly happened there, because Roadblock, as much as I know him, not one to just give up a spot that easily.
Well, I believe, if I recall, it's because he is now the champion.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yes, that did happen.
Malibu Ming is coming back out. He's bringing somebody out.
Oh, no. He went to the ring and then left to come back.
Well, clearly he's looking for a partner, and Bobby Eaton was announced to be his partner. I don't know what happened, where he is. But this is about as cluster of a fuck that WCW can truly be.
I'm glad we're starting universe mode off right.
Ming opted to take on both men.
The only way this can be better is with an unexplained Paul White heel turn.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it even happened to WCW. This has been going on his entire career.
It is far too appropriate that this is happening. And we've got a two-on-one starting things off. Malibu Meng, the current TV champion, he defeated both Johnny B. Badd and Bobby Eaton in a three-way match, knockouts only. I don't know if we have a clever name for that, but that was the stipulation. At Clash Wild, so he defeated Bobby Eaton for that. He was grown a little more rotund.
He's cultivating mass.
He is cultivating mass, yes. He's getting very vascular as well.
WCW had a name for the knockouts only match. I can't think of it right now.
What's that?
I know they had a WCW had a name for a knockouts only match.
Oh no, I'm afraid.
I know they had the tape fist. They had
is this just a
beat down?
Match. It's Bobby Eaton!
That's not.
Bobby Eaton is here! He is so winded! He is gassed as hell! By the way, Will, you're stealing
NDQ's
gimmick.
We should give props for making it down the aisle.
You're stealing NDQ's gimmick by posting pictures of that Sizzler thing. It was Sizzler, right?
You didn't post the best one. You didn't post the Sizzler girl. That licks her lips.
Well, that's a do.
No. Fuck you. There's another one that's better.
Oh my goodness. Alright, sorry, I was
saying.
Oh my god, Falcon is called Bobby Eaton the Flavortown Express. Fitz isn't here, I'm going with it. Malibu Pancakes.
Elbow Macaroni.
Oh my god. Elbow Macaroni. Oh my god, we gotta name all of his moves after food.
We have to do it now. Nasty suplex?
Well, luckily we don't have to do his finish. The Alabama Jam?
I have no idea what his finish is.
The Alabama Jam.
Alabama Jam.
It is. Yep.
I'm angry about that.
It's either that or the Denny's Grand Slam.
That's his finish.
Okay then.
That's
Split knee drop soup or split knee soup drop? Oh my god.
He's like Winnie the Pooh instead of like honey. He just gets his hand stuck in a pot of jam.
And by the way, those are green tights. Those streaks are in fact jam stains.
I knew it.
See? It helps his finish.
It gives him more velocity on that Alabama Jam. Hate myself.
Is of course here's your tag. Here you go. Enjoy your tag match before the G1.
You fuckers asked for this.
You know, we saw what those boys out east were doing.
Hey, oh my gosh. In the international waters.
I heard that's where they.
Were we both going for the same guilt?
I don't know.
Well, I was yelling woohoo, I can gamble.
Yeah, I didn't hear what Blake said.
I heard that's where they held that task secretariat fight.
Yes.
Nice. Ah, we got,
We were both referenced the same game, The Simpsons. That's fantastic.
I'm terrible at ad-libbing, but we have, joining us as well, he is free to pick whichever, unclaimed, WCW announcer you'd like. We've got Duel here.
Hello.
Oh man, hey Duel.
What's up? You made me sound like a big deal, but I'm really not.
Stop it.
Not with that attitude.
Yeah. You're big.
And Evan Courageous is a house of fire right now on Malibu Meng.
Oh god, if he was only on fire.
Well, he is going to be featured on Hour 1 of Nitro because he's in Black Block B, as well as the Black B, which I almost said. Which was almost Booker T's tag team partner.
I'm gonna start calling Duel Brad Attitude.
Oh no.
I have no idea why.
He can be Bob Caldwell.
Alright, some suggestions are either.
Well, I'm
either
not drinking.
That reference might go past a lot of our audience.
Duel, they're saying you're Soli.
Oh, sure.
You're Gordon Dooley.
I'm willing to sign off on that.
It was either that or
he. Yeah, it's better than Bob.
Come on, Bob Caldwell was pretty good. Don't hate.
It's fine. So yes, we got Block B action in the G1-900 later after this tag match. Jerry Flynn versus Damian, Mongo versus Lash LaRue, Wrath versus the Hollywood Barbarian. Any of those matches you guys actually want to see?
All of them, Brian.
Nope.
Damn.
Yeah, is someone bleeding? Is Bobby Eaton bleeding? Or is it just jam?
No. It might be
Ragu.
It's Ragu. It's
weird because we haven't seen her in years.
That's true. Match already going on longer than
marmalade.
He's tapping
again.
Well, it's like the G1 where they have that long ass table that like stretches around the ring of like Japanese commentators. We're doing that.
There's 12 of them.
And if those boys out in the Far East, Bobby Eaton submits. Evan Courageous.
Oh man,
you gotta wonder, could that be a sneak preview of the G1-900 finals?
We can
probably not.
Call that the I'm Full Nelson.
Oh my god! Yes, that's the I'm Full Nelson. That is. Is that his actual name? And we got a Malibu Man and Bobby Eaton have joined forces.
Oh god!
And apparently you can see Bobby Eaton is placing his takeout order from the second turnbuckle.
The camera had the tight.
We have the faces of food.
Oh no!
God damn it. God damn it.
Can we just get the it's the Blobby Eaton out of the way?
Blobby Eaton.
Bobby.
Oh god. Yeah, we were talking before this call, before the broadcast, about like possible things to do with like in the future, and I was like, no, we haven't exhausted all the Bobby Eaton jokes yet. All right, well now that we got that out of the way, it is time to begin the G1-900. 909-9900. Kids, get your parents' permission before watching this amazing display of sport. Because WCW, if they have one slogan that you always think of, it's where the kings of sport play.
Look at the ads.
Yes.
It is maps.
That exasperated amount of reaction is all I needed from everyone. It's like,
why do I keep doing this shit?
You are the first one to offer up yourself for it.
I know. I don't know why I keep doing it to myself, Brian. I'm a masochist.
Well, here we go. Block B is...
Also, I like having the attention.
That's fair. Block B, of course, the only... Evan Courageous, who we saw in the opening match, is on a bye for Block B first. I just want to make sure that I got the timing, everything right, that there should be... Okay, good. Yes. Everything is good. We're good here. It is now time to begin the G1-900, 909, 9900. 10-minute time limit on all these matches, as you know. Familiar with how the G1 works?
I'm not.
If you're not, the G1-900 is comprised of 14 wrestlers in two blocks of seven each. Mm-hmm. They will compete against every other person in their block, so everyone will wrestle six times. A win is worth 2 points. A loss is worth zero. A time limit draw or any other sort of draw is worth one apiece. At the end of those 7 weeks, because it's Everyone wrestles six times, and since there's seven, someone's on a bye every time. Mm-hmm. The top wrestler in the points from each block will compete in the finals, and the winner of the G1 900 909 9900 will get a shot at the WCW World Heavyweight title, currently held by Roadblock.
Of course.
You're really going to be rooting for any of these 14 at this point, because we know it is documented that Blake does not like Roadblock.
Very well documented. I used to. And then... Yeah.
And he broke your heart?
Yes.
I'm trying to think of a really funny thing to call Roadblock fans. I can't think...
Blockheads.
Blockheads doesn't work.
Or Roadhead.
Roadhead.
Roadhead works.
Also on here, by the way, I didn't introduce him. Ben Pasco, who you might know from Wednesday night. Ben plays scary games.
Yeah, that's just how I am all the time. Oh my god. Oh no.
What's that?
Oh no, they're changing guys.
Monster fear.
Face
Did Jerry Flynn get in this?
I don't know. We just picked more people. I don't know why Jerry Flynn's here either.
Just like Loki.
And here we have the
What do you do?
One of the two Lucha lawyers who are currently at odds. Better Call Damien. I believe when the LWO was short-lived, the Legal World Order, he was part of LWO pro bono.
God,
thank you, too, fans.
Really, we never really like.
I hear Better Call Damien has promised a class action of pain during this tournament.
I like that.
Legal
even,
puns.
Even
folks.
If he even if he
legal
didn't
puns.
Even if he didn't, I like the way that sounds.
I hear Damien's gonna serve as an injury lawyer to everybody he faces in this tournament.
That is a bold statement. That is some trash talking.
He's very much trash talking. Which when he's an environmental lawyer is very, very
doesn't really apply, yeah. He does elder law, it's weird.
Oh god, fuck elder law.
Have you seen his Gold Cup spraying? They're amazing.
That's true. I was trying to like translate into Spanish, slip in Jimmy so I can call him by his name. But I don't know.
Jerry Flynn will unleash a barrage. Oh god, the Loki. You guys did mention the Loki thing earlier.
Jerry Flynn will unleash a barrage of kicks.
Well, I'm a world-class striker, so I think you can only go about five.
Strike
minutes.
Shooter.
Oh god. The strike shooter.
Strike shooter, Jerry Flynn.
He lets you know the only thing he's going to be doing and you still can't stop it.
Oh my god.
He's the Mariano Rivera of shoot fighters.
Oh my goodness.
My favorite Slee story involving Loki is the one
where he's unprofessional.
A new wrestler is dropping spoonfuls of yogurt
what?
to the ground below and letting out a cooing noise. The only problem was it sounded like somebody turned up the bass way up on a CD player. The culprit, Loki.
I'm so confused as to what is going on in that story you just told.
A bunch of wrestlers were in a hotel room dumping yogurt on people but making sound like pigeons. But then one pigeon going, cuckoo, cuckoo. It's not the size of the wings on the bird, but how much flight you will get.
Oh my god, I almost died on that one. Oh, I never heard that story. That's amazing. The one I always love, and this is a more recent one I heard, was when he was working Sammy Callahan. And I guess Sammy, he goes up to Sammy and goes, "What do you do?" And said, "Muscle Buster by Better Call Damien, holy shit!"
That's exactly what he said.
Yeah, and Sammy's like, "Oh, well, you know, I do a stretch muffler." And, no. He cuts him off and just says, "No." Loki is like everyone's favorite asshole.
I mean, he was a dick to me when I met him, so...
Oh, I mean, how could anybody be a dick when they meet you?
Thanks, Brian.
Despite how much we try. And boy, do we.
You didn't try running me down outside the Philadelphia Greyhound station. I know you
wanted to. Is that really what happened?
No!
Was he trying to run you over?
No!
That's amazing.
Not yet.
I would have caught him by foot.
No, it's just... He had just turned heel in Ring of Honor, So, you know, Loki, K-Fake poops everywhere. Like, we went up to try to get a picture with him, and he just glared at us. Like, to the point where I'm like, I'm just going to go back to the party.
What do you want? What
where
do
the
you
rest
want?
Of the roster was, by the way.
Can I have a picture?
No.
Yeah, can I have a picture?
No.
You're really great on blind dates. Oh, God. Oh, by the way, Jerry Flynn kicks out of the Boston Crab.
Yeah. Kicks out of the Boston
Crab? I guess, no, it would probably be like a Mexican city, wouldn't it?
Like a pinfall?
The Tijuana Crab.
No, he literally kicked out of it, like, flipped Damien. He kicked forward and Damien flipped forward.
You only got a two on that Boston Crab.
I think that's for a link, what's his name? I don't know. Let's just figure it out. Sorry, I'm trying to keep an eye on the chat as well. Over 10 billion people watching tonight. This is amazing.
Oh,
covered
man.
By Jerry Flynn. One, two, kick out. 6 minutes left here. 10-minute time limit. All these matches. All G1, 900, 999, 900 matches.
Sorry, is there a point structure?
Yes, I already explained that. Two points for a win, 0 points for a loss, one for a draw. That includes time limit draws or any other things that do not result in a decisive winner. Jerry Flynn going for the arm bar and Better Call Damien in the ropes. He knows his rights. He knows that if he's in the ropes, the hold must be broken. Bulldog by Flynn.
So much easier.
Oh, and just wiping the mat. Just dragging around Better Call Damien, wiping the mat with him, literally. Goes for the cover.
Dominated.
Oh, and that's it. It's over.
Of course.
Jerry Flynn gets the win.
It's a virtual squash match.
I think you all remember TNA. Go ahead.
I think literally it's a virtual squash match.
Yeah. I think that's the first squash match Jerry Flynn's ever been in where he was the one that was squashing.
I don't think he's used to that. Well, Jerry Flynn gets up on a huge... I don't know. I don't even know how to talk about it. Jerry Flynn wins the match, guys. What?
Man, he's...
The GoFundMe for his training paid off.
I guess so. Which is amazing, because back then, GoFundMe, not even an idea.
It was more of a question. GoFundMe?
Yeah, GoFundMe? There we go. Okay. Which brings us to our next match.
Which is not ice training.
No, it is not. It is not Fire and Ice versus High Voltage.
It is not Red Heat Fire and Ice against the Public Enemy.
As much as we want to see that, it is Steve Mongo McMichael still with his tapeworm.
Oh, man.
Still so very tiny. It's a shame because he wanted to be a cruiserweight and then we got rid of the belt. Taking on the
We're
Raging
really kind
Cajun.
Of dicks for that.
The Raging
the pawn
Cajun.
The bigger game.
Lash LaRue. Any of you guys, your thoughts on this match? Lash LaRue coming into Block B as one of the odds-on favorites.
I'm going to say whoever wins this match will end up winning the whole thing.
Whoa.
Nobody should listen to me either.
That is a prediction.
I'm sorry, what was that, Foster?
Whoever wins this match is going to win it all, Will.
I'm sorry, I wasn't listening to you.
He did say not to listen.
Hate every single one of you.
All right, Chad, what do you guys
you
think?
Should.
Mongo. Someone's calling him Mongo Hashi. Oh my god. I love about who are figuring out... Are
trying to come up with equivalents of who, what Japanese bar... No. Like, who the equivalents are in this. I think they were saying that Wall Street's Shibata because he's potatoing the hell out of everyone. I saw Wall Street's Ishii. Renegade is Hanma. I don't know. I'm not certain that anyone is going to go 0-1-6.
Now, at this point, Renegade's Misawa.
He's Misawa? Jesus.
Oh, God.
Because
you
he's
do,
dead.
You do know that because of this, there's now Rogue Carter, right?
There's now what?
The champ. The Rogue Carter, the champ.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Oh, God. Get a chance to face Rogue Carter.
Because I was calling him Roadscape Lakamura before. Which I like Road Kata better. I really do. Mongo reminding us always to be R's.
R's.
Whatever R's is, you just should be it. They told him he could be anything, so he'd be R's.
He might not be a big fan of R's.
He really loves that wrestler from the IWS years ago.
Ours. Yes. Oh my god. It's supposed to say Ours, but it doesn't. It's a typo. And there he is, the Raging Cajun, Lash LaRue.
Yeah, my boy. This is my pick for the whole thing.
Look at how cool he looks.
Oh, he's from Las Vegas, man. He come in from Shreveport.
They're saying Road Kata is the block maker.
Nobody's ever said any of these things.
I know! No, I mean the chat is. The chat is.
No, it's not fun.
I love how disgusting Duel Miz is with all of this.
Wait, was that Mongo? Exactly.
Yeah, that was Mongo. He's got a tapeworm.
I mean, he'll just get rid of those things. He's got a Mongo like
he's still trying to be a cruiserweight.
The camera has a tendency to change your face. Right. The camera has a tendency to change your face and body completely. Don't you know that?
Yeah. Don't make Blake mansplain it to you.
Yeah.
The camera adds 10
Shut
pounds,
up.
But in Mongo's case, it's like lose 200.
It takes away
200. They both start by going for the punch right off the bat. Ah, Kawada kicks, true to fashion for a vaguely Japanese-style tournament.
Anybody remember the Bounce Glory series? Where TNA tried doing a G1?
We'd like to not. Yeah, but they made it like all weird matches and points weren't all the same. And
no,
it turns out
like,
the points didn't matter like Whose Line, except not funny.
Yeah, like you got more points for a submission than you did a pinfall win.
It made no sense.
Yeah.
But don't worry, unlike those boys down south, or those boys out in the Far East, you know, I was thinking about this. I know what's going to happen. Everyone's going to finish 3-3, and it's going to just be completely a wash. I'm going to have to flip a coin a lot of times to figure out who the finals are going to be.
You don't want to establish tiebreakers?
Oh, no. I've got tiebreakers in place, but when everyone is tied at 3-3, that's not going to work.
Anybody with sideburns in the shape of letters gets to move on.
Woo!
Here's my boy.
Yeah, Kadugan saying those boys in the Orient.
Oh, man.
Today, a woman at work referred to someone as Oriental, and I was like, I don't think you can say that.
I think that's rug that or an express, not a person.
You go John Morrison on those people, Ben.
I mean,
Orientals, people are Asian.
Rugs are Orientals, yes.
I just confirmed with Lindsay, who's Japanese, Oriental is racist unless you're referring to, like, a rug.
Yeah. Or an express.
Yeah, definitely. But it's one of the last ones.
Why did you have to go?
Oh, last
outside confirmation on that.
Standing on the brittle back of Mongo. I feel like at this point I just need to go like full on indie reference and call him Lil Mongo.
Why hasn't there been a legit Lil Mongo?
Lil Mongo, I don't know why not.
Cut Pepe into pieces.
I get it.
I'm gonna play some football. It was my first sport.
I have a brother and he wrestles, makes a lot of noises that go like this.
We're talking about Lil Mongo, not Mongo doesn't.
Grapple fuck.
Oh, the grapple fuck thing, yeah, gotcha. 10.3 billion people joining us. Thank you guys all for coming out. Thank you to all the NL people for spreading the word. I'm sure that's how this all happened.
Maybe slightly exaggerated, but.
Yeah, it's literally more than the world is watching.
From other planets. This is called Universe.
Yeah, I mean, well, clearly every house has about 10,000 people watching.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's how the Nielsen ratings work.
Yes.
That's how the Leslie Nielsen ratings work.
As somebody who used to be in Nielsen house, I can confirm.
Oh, my God. We're asking everyone in the call. People are asking who everyone in the call's pick is. You're asking picks for this match, picks to win the whole thing. I'll run down the Block B list, and you guys we'll go through and see who everyone thinks is going to win Block B overall. So we got Better Call Damien, who's on 0 points right now. Hollywood Barbarian, Jerry Flynn, who's on 2 points right now. Lash LaRue, currently in this match. Evan Courageous on a bye. Wrath and Steve Mongo McMichael currently is what's start off with Will Hudson. Who do you got?
In this match particularly?
In the entire block I just said.
Okay. That's tough. Jesus Christ.
We'll get back to you. Okay.
Yeah, what? Okay.
NTQ. he said WCW would totally say those boys in the Orient. I'm assuming he's still got his Lash LaRue pick from earlier. Duel, who would you think for this one? No, you're going to have to wait now, Will Hudson.
Jerry Flynn made me a believer.
Oh, I like the confidence. Saying a sentence that no one has ever said in their life. All right, we'll go back to Will Hudson. Who do you got in this one?
I know he lost his first round match, but I like Better Call Damien.
All right.
Former champ.
I like it. He is a former champ. That's true. We go over to the professor, Matt Fostenay.
Well, as I've said, the winner of this tournament is going to win the block, or the winner of this tournament is going to win the block. The winner of this match is going to win the block. I'm going to go with Lash LaRue.
I'm thinking Lash LaRue. A lot of people are picking Lash LaRue. Well, going for the... Oh, my God. They're doing the Japanese wrestling spot where they do the countout, and he rolls in the ring at the last minute. Every match in the G1 seems to have that spot, I swear to God. Okay, we move over to... what was the name I gave you? Stagger Blake Marshall. Who do you got?
I never thought I would say this, but I have to agree with my dear friend Duel on this. It's got to be Jerry Flynn.
Jerry Flynn.
You never say that?
He's currently in the lead.
Shh, Duel, it's okay. I'm just hyping it up for the camera.
And the living legend, Ben Zapasco.
You know, I was going to pick Lash LaRue, but, you know, a lot of great things come from out west, and the greatest thing of all is Hollywood. And a lot of the great things came from the East, and those were barbarians. So ipso facto, transitive property.
It's an East meets West sort of thing.
Yeah. Hollywood Barbarian is the whole world. If Hollywood Barbarian wins, we get world peace.
Lash LaRue, House of Fire, goes for
Jesus.
It. Oh, kick out. Kick out at two. Fighting spirit, Mongo is up. This is so like Puro. There's nothing like it at all. I couldn't.
Is there a
no-cell
setting?
It's it definitely poo.
Yeah, it's Puro. Oh my God, why are we doing this? Why do I do this to myself?
I've been asking. I don't know, Brian. It's okay, buddy.
I figure. Oh God, Mongo Spike coming up. Mongo Spike drops him on his head. Mongo Kata, I guess.
The
goes for the cover.
Make him shorter too.
One, two. Mongo gets the win.
That tapeworm ate some of his bones.
Mongo is on 2 points.
Are you changing your pick, Monster? You said the winner would go all the way.
It's
and clearly,
I'm locking my pick.
And as you can see, Mongo Takeri. I'm loving the New Japan revolution. Mongo clearly. Charles Robinson showing concern. They're holding hands. Enjoy that.
He's actually checking his pulse.
Yeah, to see if he has one.
Yeah, I mean, tapeworms are serious business, you guys.
Has nobody told Mongo the Cruiserweight title isn't a thing anymore?
It's best that we kind of just let him figure it out himself.
He might sue us.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Main event, night one of the G1 900, and then you guys get to participate in Hardcore Thunder. Charles Red Shoes Robinson. God damn it. Oh no. Oh no. These are things that are happening.
Hey, Brian, how many Vianos do you have?
I have two Vianos. I have both 4 and 5.
Oh,
they are both the same one. They were not on Community Creations, so Fitz made one. And I said, hey, can you just make a sec? Can you just, like, make a second one because I'm lazy? Oh, no, sorry. I put the number. I put the I in front of the V. I was just like, I'll just download it twice. Whatever, it's fine. So, whew. All right, lots of people.
By the way, if you want to have some fun and you watched Triple Mania last week,
oh Jesus!
Find Court Powers podcast following it. It is 10 minutes of him just saying "I'm sorry" over.
Wow! Oh, that's uncomfortable. Because didn't he have to? Wasn't he basically doing the production of it?
Yep.
Yes.
Oh, that's uncomfortable.
Wasn't it something that like kind of wasn't his fault happened?
Like, Conan's fat. I'm mad.
I guess they broke the box commentary was going through, which is why there were sound issues.
Goddamn, Young Bucks came in here, fucking super kicked the whole thing. Fucking show sucked. I don't know why Go Fight Live, those motherfuckers, they fucking don't know how to work. You know, back when me and Dennis Condry were fucking banging raps.
Okay, Pasco, there's two things about that. Number one, Jim Cornette would never use the internet. Number two, he would not be watching Triple Mania on said internet.
Thirdly, what's he doing in Mexico?
We're assuming he's at home watching it. He would not be setting a foot.
I'm in fucking San Antonio, motherfucker.
Oh my god.
I'm a big Spurs fan, baby. You know, fucking Tim Duncan. That guy knows how to fucking.
Of course, he would like the old players.
Yeah.
Thank you. Fuck you. Bye. My CD. That is.
Fucking the wrestling business is dead.
Yeah. In the meantime, while this I was gonna tell people to find the classics of Jim Cornette being wrong, which is a great parody someone made.
So hi guys.
What's that now?
You have to make it quick.
Oh, it's rap.
No. Wrath.
All right, let's go ahead and move on from Wrath. I think first time we'll do entrance to survey, then afterwards we'll just kind of skip the entrance.
Yeah.
A little more taste of WCW Universe mode. And up there he comes, driving out in his lovely vehicle that he
stole from Alberto Del Rio.
I was gonna say he bought from Alberto Del Rio Motors.
Yeah,
baby. Oh, you know. The Hollywood Barbarian, you know, he demanded to be in the main event slot.
We're all afraid of him, so we gave him what he wanted.
What a jerk.
I'm a proof glass.
I just remember Los Ingobernables.
I can't dance. I can't sing.
That's true. Wrath is our Naito, because he's just coming out in the mask and everything like that, and then he just gets undressed. Oh, well, he's getting undressed fast, I guess, not slowly.
The only thing about me was that tag team with me.
Oh my god. Yes, he was one half of the Meng on film. They have not been tagging for a while. Malibu Meng and the Hollywood Barbarian, obviously representing different areas of California, where they both now reside.
Did the drought lead to their split?
I think they both got their egos got too big for each other.
I heard a banana led to their split.
Ah, that would do it too. nice
how
impression there.
To dox new legacy.
Oh, God. Someone said Rat's gonna win the entire tournament. That's bold. That's possible. Like,
we should have done a pick'em with like everybody.
Oh god, yeah, because that's the no.
Because that's something you would love to do with your free time.
I was gonna say, yeah, like if you suggest it, then you're gonna be running it. And it's a little too late. We've already started now.
Suddenly, it's a bad idea, isn't it, Ben?
Oh, it's a terrible idea. Much like Ben plays scary games every Wednesday. Okay.
Chill.
No.
That's one.
Chill week.
Alright, locking up again. Nice slow methodical pace. Again, the toll it takes on your body to be wrestling 6 matches in such a short amount of time with so much on the line. Like, everyone's gonna be bringing it their all. Fatigue could be playing a factor, as I'm sure we'll see since Bobby Eaton is in Block A.
Oh, Fat Eaton.
Oh my god.
Oh.
I was gonna say, who is Bobby Eaton in all of this, guys, as far as New Japan comparisons?
Okay, Bono.
American Balloon.
Oh, Jesus.
Jumbo Saruta, who was
Jumbo wasn't Slice bad. Saruta. Eaton is Tenzan, oh my god, he is. He really is. Like, blown up after 3 minutes, yeah, that's about right.
Oh, you're so delicious.
Oh god.
Oh, I just want to eat and go back to catering.
I was talking to Bobby Eaton about like what his strategy is in this G1 900, 909, 9900. His answer, snacking.
Bad diet, Fale.
Bad diet, Fale. Oh my god. Oh, damn it.
Falcon said Fale. I had a bad diet. That was
the
team effort.
Damn it. That's it. Bad diet.
And if he ever starts losing weight, he can be good diet Kale.
Or bad diet Filet.
Filet. He's bad luck Filet.
Fuck Filet.
I'm loving this. This is great.
I love that I'm coming to universe mode about like halfway through you guys doing it. So just trying to figure out the natural progression of all these gimmicks.
Oh, that's fine. No, it's fine. We're happy to do, especially if you're going to chat if you're new to this. We'll give as much of a backstory as we can explain, because some of it's just weird and stuff happens. Oh! Big boot!
I can't wait till one day everybody isn't what they started as.
Oh, it's gonna happen eventually.
Oh, yeah, dude.
But, yeah, also, if you haven't already, please do give the channel a follow. We appreciate it. We do this a couple times a month. We'll be doing it a little bit more frequently right now, because we know that it's fun and popular, and it's just people like it. So, and plus the G1 900 is a lot of matches. But, you know, kicked each other in the groin. That was awesome.
The groin!
They both literally kicked each other in the dick at the same time and reacted simultaneously.
Splendid.
That's wonderful. Wrath putting the boost on DDT! No number needed afterwards.
Oh, I get it.
Picks up Barbarian, sidewalk slam. Barbarian shoves him off. Getting to the halfway point of this 10-minute time limit on all these fights, all these matches. Sound like I'm commentating HCL at this point. Oops.
You mean Layton's commentating HCL?
Well, no, I am, because I'm Brian. It sounds like I'm commentating HCL.
Touché, I'm sorry.
Did he just go for the Bomaye? Did Rat just do the Bomaye? Does that count? Can we count that as the Bomaye? I'm counting that. Why not? Ratsuke Nakamura.
God.
Who is Toro? Yeah, Disco is Toro. Disco. Toro Disco. Ryan Clark Amora, of course it is.
Everything is awful.
Yeah, Disco Inferno is totally Ariano.
Everything sucks when you're trying to breathe.
Oh god. Oh, drops the elbow. Going for the springboard. I don't even know what he's trying to do. He's just like flailing and then just lands on the mat near him. It doesn't look like he's going to move.
Raph's got like 50 variations of the elbow drop.
Raph's like hitting like 7 moves in a row. This is insane.
Japanese wrestling.
He really is. This is totally a fucking Japanese.
He's the Michael Elgin. He's just going nuts.
Going for the cover on Hollywood Barbarian. This would be huge.
Just like
he gets the
Bucky
cover and the victory.
Big Brian picks up a win.
Oh my god, Raph is on. 2 points with a. Oh my god, Disco's totally gonna try to sell his DVDs. Uh-oh. I'm hitting B. Nothing's happening.
Oh no.
Oh no, he's right. Wrath, they're liking it.
But yeah, Wrath just destroyed Barbarian. He hit like 20 moves. The monster.
Monster.
Oh my god, what's up? Oh, here comes the Lucha Lawyer, former champion Cyclope.
Oh no.
Oh, El Lord. Abogado. And he just chucks the Hollywood Barbarian out of the ring. And looks like he's shown his support. Cyclope had an opportunity to join, to take a Roadblock spot in the G1 900. Injuries prevented him from doing it because, well, Roadblock beat the fuck out of him. I think he's made his selection. He is backing Wrath.
Oh, man.
I guess Wrath is Okada and Cyclope is Gedo now. It's got to be.
It has to be the thing now.
I don't like
that
any of
cannon.
This.
It might as well be at this point.
It's Eric Cannon.
He's El Abogado now.
Abogado. God damn it.
All right. For that, I apologize. And for that, it is time for Hardcore Thunder.
Hardcore Thunder!
Is everybody's thoughts on Raph getting some legal support now?
That's true, he now has legal support.
I think I'm going to change my pick to Raph. Am I allowed to do that, Brian?
Sure, you can absolutely, because you're not betting money or anything like that. So it is time for Hardcore Thunder. Yep. And I feel like there's a lot of people who I may need to explain Hardcore Thunder to.
Explain away!
Hardcore Thunder is... It's Hardcore Thunder. It's three matches every week. The Hardcore Champion, whomever that is at the time, defends the belt in that match. The first match is a singles match. The second match is a three-way dance. The third match is a four-way dance. If the time limit of 10 minutes is reached, then no matter whether he was eliminated or not, the champion retains. Must be a winner. Our current champion is Alex Wright, Das Wunderkind. And
oh, man.
I'm going to... You know what? Because he hasn't been on one of our streams in a very long time. Duel, would you like to select Alex Wright's first opponent? The only thing is just someone that's not in the G1 900.
Alright, you're gonna need to go down the roster.
Any WCW, like, lower tier guy is probably on here.
Just think of the first hour of Nitro.
Yeah, pretty much.
Alright, Maestro.
You want the Maestro, I like it. Yes, we have the Maestro.
La la.
We absolutely do. Ooh la la, indeed. NWA Mountain State. You want Kane 02?
The best to die.
Oh, Diablo Jr. Oh, no. Yeah, hey, Fitz is in here. Sorry, I just broke kayfabe.
Oh, man.
The running gag is that Diablo Jr. is Fitz.
Because I thought it was Will.
Is that why we said that?
What? No. Like him?
Is that why we said it? Because it kind of sounds like him a little bit, only not really?
I don't think anything sounds like Diablo Jr.
That's true. Nothing can. It's unearthly. The likeness of the Maestro is uncanny. Seriously.
You know me. I'm Ricochet.
Who was the one guy? You know what's great about me? Everything.
Scotty Rocker. You know
Johnny Rocker.
I'm Johnny Rocker. You know what's great about me? Everything. It's like, wait, dude. You gotta give me a chance to guess.
He says it 5 seconds. Universal Hot Dog. Scotty Rocker. What's great about me? Everything.
I'm sorry, it's so loud. It's so loud, but it's Hardcore Thunder.
Welcome to the violent world.
Frank Parker. Labby Fresh.
I'm Dynamite Derek Dillon. This is a legit hit to the... We're legit Dynamite.
Ugh, it's the worst thing ever. And of course, okay, Josh.
Lacey Von Erich?
Okay, Jacques.
Her name, her family's in the Wrestling Hall of Fame. Her claw holds vicious, not fictitious. Lacey Von Erich, she's wrestling.
Okay, Jacques. we're gonna say action, and we just need you to kind of like introduce yourself, say your name, maybe a quick little quip, like just a sentence. That's all we need, dude. Okay. All right. And action. How you doing, everybody? Okay, Jacques. Just say your name.
Oh, okay.
And we just need you to just like a little quip, just even just your name. Okay, so let's go ahead. We're still rolling, and action. I wasn't sure if you were going to do it or not.
Oh, okay. I didn't want to stop.
And action.
How's it going, everybody?
Okay, you got the line wrong. I'm back to doing it myself. How you doing, everybody? Okay, fine. We'll just go with it. Oh, we'll just post it in the chat.
One half of the greatest Southern announced team in Southern West Virginia.
I am totally stealing that line for something in the future. Oh my god. And of course, in true hardcore weight title fashion, we won't use any sort of plunda until about halfway through this match. So they're working like indie deathmatch style, I guess. Yeah, and of course, always is the rule with Hardcore Thunder, if a table is set on fire, it will not be used.
Who's the fucking man?
I feel like it had to be put in there because there's a lot of new people that don't know what the fuck we're talking about.
Alex effing Wright, oh no. No, no, no. Alex high waist right. Yeah, seriously. Like, you can see the extra layer that someone gave him that.
Well, I wasn't going to say anything.
It's fine.
Maybe he just got rib tape like DDP, and it's just
and he's just gonna wear it forever like DDP. And Strowe going for superplex. Oh, back smacking the canvas, and the Strowe still not going for a weapon. Reminder to them: this is a hardcore weight title match. Why hardcore weight? Of course, because we combined that with the cruiserweight title again. No one told Mongo.
I forgot about JC Dykstra.
JC Dykes Jr. He's kind of
JC Dykes Jr.
He's kind of got an accent.
He's like faux Canadian.
I will tell you right now that there is plans in the works to introduce it to him, but also to get him to do it at some point in a promo to get the indie wrestler to say, "You know who I am. I'm Ricky Shane Page." Because we have a feeling he'd totally be for it.
The referee doing?
I don't know what the ref's doing. We got a. Oh, Strowe with the guitar!
Oh, no.
That's right, had a ladder, but Strowe with the guitar, and a fan is handing. Oh, he just took that! He took that from that belt mark! Oh, he just brained him with that belt! That belt cost that fan at least $17,000.
Where the hell is Dillinger trying to stop these fans from bringing stuff? What do we pay Doug Dillinger for?
We're not sure he's dead or not.
That hardcore way title just floating in the air.
Yes.
I use my EBT card.
You know how sometimes like people do stuff behind the referee's back? Like 80% of this match is from behind the referee's back.
Charles Robinson's just like, whatever. Charles Robinson is in the crowd. He said, fuck this, he's going home.
Alex Wright's trying to get some.
Alex Wright showing all the people what they wanted.
Oh my god, this is a train wreck.
Shit's a fat boy.
He pushed the referee to the crowd.
He just said fuck it, he's out of here. Oh my god. I don't even know what to say to this.
This sucks.
This is truly the greatest night.
Floating around. Even in the hardcore fell.
Oh my god. Oh, German suplex by Alex Wright.
Suplex.
Using.
It's just a suplex.
It's just a suplex. Sorry, you're right.
Now, can he capitalize? Of course not. He's rolling outside.
American Mice Strong style.
He doesn't have to win. Oh! He has to survive.
He brained him with the side of the guitar. He didn't use the gimmicked end of it.
Oh,
Alex,
no.
Oh god!
Alex Wright says, fuck your American music, I love synthesizers, I'm
Alex
German.
Alex Wright! Oh, a regular suplex because he's German! With the pin! Gets a one count, Maestro is up!
He's telling him that now is the time of sprockets when we dance!
Seriously, like, Alex Wright has, his moveset apparently
suplex.
Is nothing but German suplexes.
Oh.
Cover! Kick out by the Strowe.
Das Beast incarnate.
He's getting Das Beast.
Yes. I really hope this leads with Alex Wright being king of the hardcore division, and we can make Alex up and right.
He's not really, like, I mean, it's a hardcore thunder. No one holds a belt for all that long. But Alex Wright holds it for one more match. He is your winner.
Oh, man.
He has retained the title.
Who's Das Mad?
If you can find someone who can like survive like a month as champion, you should just like.
Well, we always loud it. If you survive the entire show, that's a pretty big thing. I don't know where he thinks he's going.
Wasn't the first person to do that Roadblock?
No, I don't think so. I think I feel like Bagwell probably did it. He's done it at least once.
Did.
I feel like he was
that was
the
like
first,
one of my first streams.
But I feel like he was also one of the first to do it. I'm sure. Oh, Bagwell was the first. Good. Confirmed by Ghost to Ghost Dad.
Ghost of Ghost Dad is still my favorite chat name.
That is a great chat name, yeah. As much as I want to see that as a remarkable match.
Oh, man.
It is time for the, oh my god, that main event. That main event is just a mess.
Oh, no.
That
would
be awesome.
Now I want to see Super Callow and Mr. JL in the next match.
I think they gave us a Lucha Trios match for the main event. That's really funny. Alright, so I'm going to use the chat for the suggestion. We need two opponents for Alex Wright. Again, the only catch is just that, you know, no one in the G1 900.
So who do the people want?
Both Fianos.
Both Fianos.
I mean, I kind of have to.
Oh, Jesus. I mean, Jesus.
Jesus. I mean, in honor of their dog shit match against Los Psycho Circus, I feel like I kind of have to. Minus 5 stars. Minus 5 stars. The best part is, like, they're because of what happened for no apparent reason in that match at Triple Mania, they're gonna totally go for, like, the mask rip spot, only they're gonna rip Alex Wright's skin off his face.
Oh, no. I'm more concerned about who Alex Wright's master is.
Oh, God.
Hitler.
It's clearly the wall. Oh, God.
We were all thinking it.
It's Joe Hitler. You know, that Canadian soccer player, Joe Hitler.
Mr. Hilder.
He plays for SC Manifest Destiny.
Mr. Hilder.
He plays for SC Manifest Destiny on the League of Atrocities.
Great.
Which you can watch on youtube.com/IRS.
It's Hasselhoff. It has to be Hasselhoff.
It's Hasselhoff. Oh my God, it has to be. You're right.
Adolf Hasselhoff, you guys are right.
There's just a framed photo.
Just as a reminder that Alex Wright would once again like to dedicate this match to his Führer.
David Hasselhoff.
No, we don't know who it is yet, sure.
Oh, sorry.
He's gonna dedicate this to his maestro.
Don't let the fans in on the booking meeting, man. Come on.
Bro, what we gotta do. I think it's gonna be Hitler, and it's actually Emperor Hirohito.
Nobody'll see it.
Ben, I'm sorry, but when you've actually heard Vince Russo on a Skype call, the game just went, it kind of all the impressions kind of lose the effect.
Does he still hate Blake?
Did you hit Blake? I don't know. Blake, were you on? I can't remember if you...
I was on with him. It went fine. All I know is that when you hear Vince Russo call Jervis Cottonbelly a fruitcake...
It's the first thing he says when Jervis is on. Or no, Jervis was on first, or...
Jervis was on... Vince was on, then he left. Jervis was on, then he left. Then they were both in the same call when we were playing Quiplash. And then Sidney Bacabella came in.
Which, yeah...
So we had all. So we had all three of them in the call at the same time.
Vince Russo sounds exactly what everyone's impression of Vince Russo sounds like.
Yes.
Yes.
It's bro. Amazing. It's amazing how.
So when Vince started shooting on Bacabella for trying to shill his shirts, it was the funniest fucking thing.
And I was there too.
Yeah, like, and that's the thing, like, NTQ, first time on any sort of stream call. And, like, it was sadly, like, that's a monumental thing. And it was, like, and it was just, like, it was one of many things that happened. And the thing was really awesome.
It became a sit back and just listen to.
Get the clapping right. It sounds like you're describing some weird dream. No. And then Sidney Bacabella showed up. We all played
Sidney
an online
Bacabella.
Video game. And then we all played Quiplash. Oh, stunner by one of the Vianos. Don't ask me to tell you which one's which. I don't know.
Did Bacabella have anything to say about that Jew Joey?
No, he didn't. Well, he will do that. Like, I actually asked him.
Apparently what he both... actually said!
I've talked to Bacabella, and he refers to Joey Eastman as that shyster Jew. Which is the greatest, funniest thing.
You can't make that up!
But apparently they both have sons named RoboCop.
Yes, they do. For those unfamiliar with Sidney Bacabella, he's a manager of the Devastation Corporation. It's a throwback kind of manager gimmick, because they're a throwback, like, bruiser, face paint, tag team. And Joey what? Eastman, whose name you might... Kayfabe is dead on this call, whatever. Joey Eastman plays it. So whenever he's talking about that shyster Jew, Joey Eastman, he's referring to himself.
Sorry.
Yeah, go ahead,
Blake. I was really trying to... A Totally Tool Wrestling reference, because I may be the only person alive that's watched that.
That's for the molester.
Not anymore!
The thing was, years ago when we started the YouTube channel, one of the first things I made for it was an Uncle Chester CAW, and apparently Uncle Chester saw it and responded to it, saying the bulge wasn't big enough.
Totally Tool Wrestling is like if New Legacy and IRM and all these things were like real and really happened.
Thanks for including us in that thing. I appreciate it, man.
Yeah, Totally Tool Wrestling was my inspiration for wanting. Yeah.
Except it really, like, really happened. Like,
yeah, exactly.
People did it.
And that's the way we pretty much envision if we ever do, in some slim chance in hell, run a show. It's just going to be Totally Tool Wrestling Part 4.
The greatest thing that ever happened to Totally Tool Wrestling was it was Jesus versus a terrorist.
It was Jesus versus
Muhammad.
Yeah.
Is it Al Qaeda or something like
and
that?
And then
I've got the DVD over here.
Oh, God, they shook hands, and then Jesus turned around and he yelled terrorist attack.
No. It's Rabbi Albert Goldstein versus Sheikh Mala Malacca. I'm holding the DVD box in my hand. So Sheikh his hand, just yells terrorist attack, and then just hits him from behind.
And then
the finish to that match was the devil comes out.
Who might the devil be?
WWF champion Seth Rollins.
Yes! That's the craziest fucking thing.
Wait, what? Really?
Wrestling.
Wearing a female's devil costume.
This is footage that WWE will never buy for the Seth Rollins DVD. Is what you're saying.
Stabs the rabbi, and then the terrorist comes in, and then they shake hands. The announcer says, "We now have world peace."
The rabbi should have no-sold it because I believe Jewish people don't believe in hell.
Oh, what happened was,
God, the piano just got brained in the back of the head, by the way, while this match is happening.
What happened was the devil attacks both of them, and the referee comes out and says he has a delivery for the devil. And it's an envelope full of anthrax.
Oh my God.
It gets the powder spine to the face. They both pin the devil, and they shake hands and hug. And the ring announcer goes, "The winner of this match is everyone because we now have world peace."
That's amazing.
The other great thing was it was Ian Rotten and Ed Schulman competed in the first ever.
Oh, the first man standing match. Ed Schulman, rest in peace, versus Ian Rotten. They both were duct taped to folding chairs, and the first man to stand up won. It was the funniest. Didn't it take part throughout the entire show? Like it was happening outside the ring, while other matches were going on.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
It's Schumann and Ian trying to struggle to stand up out of a chair.
I think Totally Tool Wrestling also is where Twinkie the Kid, which is just Cabana wrestling in a Twinkie costume,
and a false count somewhere match. Like all
false
these insane things happen.
False count somewhere is my favorite gimmick ever.
Totally Tool Wrestling. Good
just
Lord.
The first man standing.
Yes, it was a first man standing match. It was two guys duct taped to folding chairs.
I hate this so much.
It was the most brilliant thing ever, which is why you should hate it so much.
Because after it ended, Ian cuts this promo and acts like he's going to blast him in the face with a chair, and he's just like, what, he just farts on him?
Oh God, we got a flaming table, you guys. The Vianos are going off script, as we kind of expect them to.
Oh, Jesus.
Because they're dicks.
Jesus, I mean. Sorry.
Oh, Jesus. And the other Boricuas.
First man standing, the only match I can never win.
Oh.
Oh, man. Darkest sketch.
Darkest sketch. Oh, dropkick to the face. Other Viano has a guitar. I just brained his brother. Viano 5 just hit Viano 4 with a guitar. And there's still a flaming table. No one seems to be too concerned about it.
Oh yeah, I have a match from Totally Tool Wrestling ready to post in the chat for you guys.
I'm so sorry, but I love it that Viano went to the top rope to go for the top rope leg drop, and Alex Wright picked up the other Viano instead, and Viano just did the leg drop anyway.
that match is a Stone Cold Sal Tomaselli versus Mark Kayfabe.
Oh my God, so great! He mouthed it, and like someone else did the.
Hey Webb. Nate
yeah,
was behind him in Stone Cold impression.
Yeah.
Oh no! I mean, why is that someone shocked him?
Hey, those two are loosely related.
Yeah, I know. It's shocking.
Oh, also, my favorite thing from all Totally Tool.
Listen.
Not really hurt that badly for some reason.
My favorite thing besides Uncle Chester, of course, was the Commander. In the third volume.
Which one did you show us? You only showed us the first one, right?
It showed you the second one.
Oh, the second one? Okay. Really, no one has been eliminated from this match.
I'm pretty sure the Commander is based on... Is he based on the Creator?
And I don't...
Which is...
Viano just completely missed the leg drop and is selling the head.
Oh, God.
I don't know why.
A lot of, like, the Totally Chill Wrestling stuff are in-jokes that we would never understand.
You know what I love is that this match involves two Vianos, and it's about as much of a train wreck as the Triple Imani. It's so true. It holds true to form.
These guys are fucking stupid.
Stupid. It is seriously amazing how accurate, how true to form this match is. No one is going to get pinned. I feel like this is going to happen. And we're going to need three new people for the next match.
Viano 4, Viano 5, and Viano Senior.
Oh my god.
Or Viano Senior, if Duel's booking this.
Mark Kayfabe is such a great fucking
team. Yes, it is.
And because Alex Wright gets the pin on one of the two Vianos. I don't know which one it is just yet.
That was Viano...
High.
Oh, no.
I think it's 5.
If Bob Eaton becomes a Viano, he's Viano Pie.
High. Oh, it was Viano 5 has been eliminated. It looks like Alex Wright just needs to survive the next 5 seconds. He will do it. The match is over.
I'm begging you.
Alex Wright, still a champion, as he gets stomped on the back of the head by Viano. What the hell just happened? Good lord.
Bruiser
Brody. And of course the table stayed ablaze for 5 minutes.
We
never got used.
A table that was never used. True to form in WCW Universe mode.
Well, I mean, it was kind of used, because one of the Vianos hit the other Viano, and they fucking smacked it right on the table and just got straight back up.
Oh my god. I'm going to have to rewatch that and find out if the table was ever used in any sort of way.
No,
of course one
not.
Of the Vianos,
what a silly
like,
thing.
Got smacked on, like you could whip somebody into it while it's standing.
Alright, well, Alex Wright, despite that horrid match, needs 3 more opponents, you guys.
El Padre Hardcore. I mean, it's under the chat, but...
Mr. JL.
He's just going the Lucha route? He's going the Lucha route? Mr. JL, okay.
Silver King.
There is a request for Silver King, alright?
So, Super Calo.
And this show should be called World War 4, because it's Alex Wright versus the world.
It really is. Are there multiple, like, attires for him? What the hell? Oh my god, his mask stuff! That's kinda cool. I probably have looked through that before and...
Silver King in the North!
And who was the last one someone wanted?
Super Calo.
Super Calo, there we go.
Whatever.
We have... Yeah, it was the same thing. We have El Padre Hart all the time, that's why I was like, let's get some new guys. We don't have the wall, sorry.
We don't
have the wall, brother. He's too high up. He got the rub from Hogan, so that makes him too popular.
Oh, can Super Calo become a womanizer and become Super Coolo?
Oh my
god. Are you on the first floor or a floor above the first floor?
I don't know where this journey's taking me, but I'm sure I'm
Oh, it's taking you to the bottom, wherever you are.
To the basement.
I thought you were making it. My name is Luca. I live on the second floor.
Silver King, big Game of Thrones fan. I want Mr. JL to just be like, try to be a cool guy,
but he's like a dad because he's Mr. JL, so he just doesn't know how to be cool.
Hey, you kids, right down there, you need anything else? We're fine, Mr. JL.
You guys want to listen to some old Richard Pryor
I got
albums?
I got some Kansas records.
No, man.
Oh, God.
Mr. JL.
It's actually this Kansas cover band where Drew McIntyre plays bass.
I got it. Mr. JL and Super Kelly.
Yes!
That's a throwback
Mr.
reference.
Mr. JL, but very... Holy shit, that callback. fucking Jesus Christ. I don't even know what I was going
to
say.
We had Mr. JL come out to More Than a Feeling by Boston Mail.
God, the greatest rock song of all time, Boston's More Than a Feeling.
That's from Boston.
I couldn't say it in the Carl from Aqua Teen voice, but that is a Carl line.
Greatest song of all time.
Yeah. It's the greatest song of all time. Boston's More Than a Feeling. That's what it's saying.
Sounds more like Kingston than
exactly. Oh, hey. It's more than a feeling. Hey, Lionel Richie! Nothing is more frightening than Eddie Kingston. Than Eddie Kingston excusing himself through a bar. Like, moving himself through a bar. Yelling at the top of his lungs. Lionel Richie! Terrifying. Because you know the night is going to end with him singing Lionel Richie.
Yeah.
the blind girl making the clay head of him is Jigsaw.
Oh my God. It has to be. It has to be.
Jigsaw, it was you. It's so fucking gay.
Mr. JL should team with Super Calo so Super Calo can teach him how to be cool.
Oh my God. Are we really going with Super Coolo?
No, he doesn't have to be Super Coolo, but Super Calo wears backwards hats and baggy clothes. He's a cool dude.
That's true.
Are you doing it for the double meaning, Pasco?
Yes. The man is a walking pun book.
He's a walking... Something.
Now go ahead and picture that scene from Footloose with those two guys.
He's got great penmanship.
It's my gift, it's my cursive. Shoot me.
Once I'm going, you'll be shooting.
Oh, Silver King coming to the corner. Man, and Super Kalo has a mop.
That's racist.
You were about to say
he got it on his own accord. That was not. They're going off script. It's Hardcore Thunder.
He brought that boom mic into the ring.
And Mr. JL going down to the basement, going into the garage, pulling out a table. It looks like that's where his workshop is.
Damn it,
Dad.
Where he keeps his train set.
He's setting it up. He's apparently going to be setting up his train set outside the ring.
That's where he's making some cornhole for the kids.
I love it. I'm okay with this whole thing being a thing.
Oh my. Reddit is going after Scott.
Wait, what?
It could be anybody.
You completely. Reddit, Scott, it could even Scott, be Scott Boat.
Okay. My back?
Your connection's been kind of shit the whole night.
Go to our Reddit correspondent, Matt Foster.
Yeah, Reddit correspondent, Matt, the professor, Matt Fostenay.
They want Scott Steiner for an AMA.
Yes.
I think his fingers are too muscular to type.
I think everything the date gets.
Hopefully so he just answers every question like Joe Kahn.
Oh,
which is he doesn't answer any questions.
Boring AMA ever, just like his product.
I think that he's a very talented individual, and I hope we have him in the future.
Oh, Super Kalo thrown into the table by Alex Wright. Mr. JL's not going to like this.
What do you think about...
body slams him through the table. That is roughhousing that Mr. JL will not stand for.
Alex Wright has gone to dark places.
He really is. And he is trying to please his Führer.
Whoever it is.
Mr. JL, Rana... I don't know if that was actual count. I think it was just a two count. Yep, Mr. JL's still in it.
He's
I don't know if Mr. JL had a gimmick before, but I like the idea of him being a dad.
He's trying to play his fear of Mr. Colonel Plink.
Like, the best thing about Mr. JL being the dad, I don't need to really do any edits to the call, which I like. I like when I have to do less work.
Just give him a nice jacket.
Like a flannel shirt. And
there's actually a smudge on your note sheet. It just says
just a,
father.
Just a pair
just
of denim.
Father.
Just a pair of shorts that go a little bit uncomfortably above the knee.
It'll be over his gear, by the way. Like, I'm
that
not
way,
gonna, like,
would it be up. A flannel shirt, or would it be a button-up shirt with a t-shirt underneath?
No, it'd be a Tommy Bahama shirt.
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm.
Pile driver by JL! Cover on Silver King! Oh, kick out. Alex Wright kicks out. Mr. JL going for the cover. Charles Robinson busy counting the other pin. But Super Kalo is out. He is grounded, mister.
Wonderful.
Oh, Silver King brains Mr. JL with the steel chair. He's got a mop now. Again, this is totally not racist.
He stole that mop from Horseshoe.
Yes. Who from Horseshoe's professional jizz mopper, actually.
Oh, God.
Oh, Duel, have you seen Horseshoe yet?
Just say yes.
No. Yeah, I don't want to see it.
You really don't. You're right.
No, you don't.
We hear it.
We
it's raining, Meg. Sometimes go too
now.
Far.
Sometimes?
It's really good at making everyone feel super uncomfortable.
An attempt for humor.
3 minutes to go. Again, Alex Wright is working the clock really well so far. He knows that he just needs to survive. Three guys still alive in this match. Only Super Kalo has been eliminated. We're down to 2 minutes and 48 seconds of this time limit. Alex Wright going for the pin on Silver King, though.
I wish Blitzkrieg was in this game so I could team with Alex Wright.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man.
The smartest,
was
dumbest
Blitzkrieg
joke
an actual? Was Blitzkrieg an actual luchador? Was he one of the guys like under? Was he like someone under a mask?
He was a SoCal guy who famously had his tryout with Super Dragon.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he was like a California guy who wrestled with the... He wrestled for like 2 years and killed it every time.
Okay, so he was an actual like Mexican wrestler. He was a SoCal dude.
Yeah, he was a SoCal dude.
Okay. No, I think, as a matter of fact, there was a joke about that because there was an episode of... it was either Nitro or Thunder where Guerrero made all the luchadors take their masks off because someone sold his wallet. Huh. And the punchline was, man, I thought you were... Mexican when he got up to Blitzkrieg.
Oh, so he did do it to Blitzkrieg. That's really funny.
Yes.
Mr. JL spiked with the DDT. Oh, Alex Wright just brained Silver King with the chair.
Other highlights of that were that I think Eddie Guerrero found a long-lost cousin and one of his former best friends underneath the mask of luchadors.
Racist Eddie.
Mr. JL goes for the cover on Silver King. Knows he's got to win it. Silver King again, kicking out at one.
Oh, that wasn't so much racist as Eddie Guerrero being a horrible, being a horrible.
It was. There were plans for Jack Evans going to be Blitzkrieg too, but then in his first match with him, he like I think the gear like
didn't work.
Messed him up, and he got really hurt. He almost got really hurt, and then that was the only time Blitzkrieg 2 ever existed.
By the way, I want to squash a whole lot of rumors that Silver King is not in fact reincarnated now as Tejano. I think he's like his uncle though, right? Isn't Silver King Tejano like? Uncle Silver King or something.
They look
like that.
Remarkably like.
Well, because I know, like, Tejano, like, the original Tejano was Silver King's tag partner as Los Cowboys. Which is just really not that creative of a title.
Los Cowboys.
Except for
I
the
want
fact
to
that
be a cowboy.
Like, I can't think of something stupid for cowboy to mean in Spanish, damn it.
Yeah. I've definitely. I can tell you that Los Cowboys. Are on the IWA King of the Deathmatch tournament that has like Cactus Jack versus Terry Funk. They wrestle the Headhunters. Mr. JL has been eliminated. It's down to with 26 seconds to go. Silver King and Alex Wright. Alex Wright just has to survive, and he will what's the word I'm looking for? He will complete
run
the feat
gauntlet.
That is amazing. He will run the gauntlet. 12 seconds to go. Silver King goes for the... He drops something. Completely missed most of everything. I don't know what he was even going for. But he's going to go for it again. Rana! And Alex Wright survives. After just elbowing him right on the knee. Jesus, what a dick.
No salt the last move just so you don't lose.
Pretty much. Well, Alex Wright, still your champion. He has run the gauntlet. Here at Hardcore Thunder, unprecedented, well, except for the fact that a bunch of other people have done it now, but it is truly an amazing feat, and it's time to continue the G1 909 9900.
Gave him like a Charlie horse at the end.
He did.
As to say, as to say, haha, you can't beat me. I'm going to be a bully now.
He told me I could be anything I wanted, so I became a bully. Alright, we are going to start customizing this. So it is time for the G1-900-909-9900. Block A first matches. And we're getting things started in a big way. And again, we're going to go around the horn and see what people's picks are once we get this first match started. Our first match involves the Renegade.
Oh boy.
Taking on the Toroyano of this tournament, the Disco Inferno.
Oh man.
That's my pick.
Disco, you picking Disco?
I'm going with Disco.
Nice. I like it. He's going to be shilling his DVDs wherever I can find Disco.
I think it's going to be Disco Demolition that, but.
You just passed him.
There we go.
I like rock, I like soul, I like pop, but I never like disco.
Oh my god.
Well, I think that when it comes to the Renegade, the jig is up and he finally found him.
That's racist.
He is not, in fact, Lorenzo. We made the joke already, but I made the joke already. Was Lorenzo Lamas in Renegade?
Yes.
Okay, got it.
90s television. Yes. You
well,
got it.
That's why I'm asking you guys.
Welcome to my wheelhouse.
Out of my house.
I got a house made of tires.
Nazi television and Boston Sports.
Not even Boston Sports. Boston Sports up until about 2004.
Oh, okay.
And Aaron Hernandez.
Aaron Hernandez.
Oh my god.
He was framed. I'm just saying, Tim Tebow in Florida State, I'm sure that the murder rate skyrocketed. No one ever talks about that.
Florida, not Florida State.
Well, the state of Florida. What are you, fucking stupid?
No, I really don't know
what
to say.
Oh,
get
no.
Upright.
Yeah, I have a buddy of mine. I heard a couple people from my cousin, Dora, my sister, Denise, and my buddy, Arms for Legs, Jeff, and we call him that because we call him that.
What's his name?
Arms for Legs, Jeff. We call him that because he passed out on the commuter rail on the way to Lawrence, and there was so many scattered parts, and the doctor figured he'd just switch them and it'd be the same. So, you know, he fucking, you know, walks around on all fours with some kind of act.
Arms for Legs Johnson.
Yeah, he's Hooker Denise's brother.
Oh, alright.
Yeah, they call her that because, like, she likes to put on vaudeville shows, and then, like, this giant bug comes off and pulls her off screen. And also, she has sex with men for money.
My god.
Renegade has become our Hanma because he does the Kokeshi bump. He just kind of falls off the apron.
It's like a charming coincidence in the actual, literal definition.
That's the old town, bro.
And here comes.
I like Disco Inferno.
Disco Inferno.
I love this entrance, pal.
It's uncomfortable.
So uncomfortable.
Especially
it's just
with
like,
no music.
Get a look at all that crotch. Look at all that crotch.
Look at all that disco dick.
Oh, 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 oh.
Oh no! It wouldn't be so bad if not for the screens behind
it. I know,
it.
It's crotchception. Sorry, it's groinception.
Infinite dicks.
Infinite dicks.
Crotch city.
Crotch city.
Time is a flat circle next to another flat circle with a big oval overlapping it.
I just picture Joey Styles being like, he's groin! And that's also his groin! And that's his groin!
He has 12 groins!
Oh my god, get the clamp, says he's selling 8 tracks. Yes he is. Yes he is. Disco Yano. I love it. Alright, well, gentlemen, I'm gonna go over the list of Block A.
I'll be right back.
Yeah, okay. We have The Renegade, VK Wall Street, Bobby Eaton, Tom Zenk, Disco Inferno, Prince Iaukea, now currently known as Cancer, and La Parca, because he's one of the signs of the Zodiac, and La Parca. Who do you guys think? Let's go with Will Hudson.
You know what? In this block, it's tough. I like Cancer, though, to be honest.
Prince Iaukea, now known as Cancer, one member of the Signs of Zodiac.
But I have a dark horse pick.
Who's your dark horse?
Husky Harris.
Ah, he does occasionally show up once in a while.
He just shows up.
He just shows up and congratulates people. NTQ, would you like to...
Tom Zenk.
You got Tom Zenk. Duel, you have a pick in this
which
one?
Which commentator am I?
I don't know. We didn't have a... Well, you're a better Shivani than I am, but...
Can I beat anybody that's ever announced?
What's that?
Can I beat anybody who's ever announced?
Sure. It helps if they're WCW, but you know, whatever.
All right. Magnum TA.
All right. Magnum NTQ. I like it.
Oh, God.
Got the initials, so there you go. That means we gotta put you next to Missy Hyatt for when we do Lethal Lottery.
Don't worry, herpes isn't contagious through the air, I think.
Leave her alone, that woman is a saint.
No, she's not, she's terrible.
She's the opposite of the saint, that's okay. Duel, do you have a pick for Block A? Gordon Dooley?
Say anger.
I think we lost Duel. We lost Duel on that one. Professor Matt Fostenay.
I believe that Bobby Eaton is going to devour the competition. Tense. And make it out of the Block A as the winner.
That's appropriate.
Thank you. I try.
That's appropriate. Who else we got? Let's go to. We've got. Is Duel still? Oh, Duel still there. Okay. And he's there. And of course, living legend Ben Zapasco.
Malibu Meng, is he in the Block A?
No, he was not. Malibu Meng is a champion, so he's not in the. He's not in the in the G1900. Block A is again Renegade, VK Wall Street, Bobby Eaton, Tom Zenk, the Disco Inferno, Cancer, and La Parca.
I mean, motherfucking La Parca. Because Hollywood Barbarian is going to face La Parca, and it's going to be death versus life, and then we will have world peace.
Wow. Wait, so Hollywood Barbarian is life to you?
Well, we've established previously. Okay. Is there anything more to that life that is Hollywood than his movies? How would we know what to wear, what to think, what people we could make fun of? It's the Ben Show, starring me and Ben, hanging out, watching streams. This is in my head.
Meanwhile, we've got Renegade and Disco Inferno. I don't know who the champions is going to win Block A, as I've been mentioning the names quite a bit. Anyone in the chat would like to make their picks for Block A?
Good poll.
Because in true WCW fashion, we're going backwards. We'll start with B and then going to A.
The Baracus theory.
Ben, they're saying you turned it into, think you turned this into philosophy. Johnny's saying that Disco couldn't even beat Vince Russo. It's true. Vince Russo is still riding a streak in Backstage Assault. The streak is officially at 5-0, but according to the crowd and the commentators, it is currently 17,484-0.
Benedict Goldberg.
anyone else got a pick for Block A? Guessing not. Literally no one in the chat is. Someone's got Bobby Eaton. Falcon said him. Bobby Eaton got La Parca. Those are all names.
Renegade Bump.
I think La Parca's gonna be the favorite.
Mongo La Parca final. Ooh. They have feuded in the past. They had a match over the Mongo Spike and the Tombstone Piledriver. Did we get the Renegade Bump? Did I miss the Renegade Bump? Oh my god! NTQ, I missed the Renegade Bump? What the hell?
Just happened.
Oh! I have to go back to the loot chat. Which, by the way, now that I'm not stupid, I put the entire stream will go up on YouTube as soon as I'm able to. Likely tomorrow. So give the YouTubes a follow. All of our links are below.
A lot of fun stuff this week. We'll be back with more WCW Universe Mode on Tuesday night. 8:30 Eastern is the start time, so a half hour later than when we started tonight. Wednesday, I believe we got Kyle replays his childhood. He's going to be playing Plock. I have no idea what that is. And then, Ben, are you doing something afterwards, too?
Yes, I'm going to play some more scary games.
All right, and Ben's going to do a little late-night stuff, playing some scary games. We'll totally do it because he's a wimp. But so am I. That's why I'm not even on the stream and watching it, because it's like, no thank you.
It was so unfun.
I can't tell you how many times, like, when I was watching the video back, I was, like, pausing, much like you were with the game. And I was, like, scrolling down the page so, like, only the bottom of the video so it didn't jump scare me. I am such a wimp, so that's why you were doing exactly what I'd be doing. You're actually playing it.
It's so uncomfortable.
Because I value self-preservation. And Thursday night. What do I got Thursday night on the list? I think we currently have Steiner on there. I don't know. Fitz was going to do something. If that kind of falls through, we might do a little WCW, because why the hell not? Oh, my God! Oh, capture suplex! Is that the Regalplex? Renegade gets the win!
Wow.
Renegade.
Good for the Renegade.
On 2 points. Oh, he's
so unpredictable. The Renegade.
So much for him being the Hanma. He actually wins the first match. Yeah, we need a new Hanma. You're right. No, we're not going to know who the Hanma is until, like, about, like, four matches in when someone's on zero. All right, thankfully, we're going to get rid of Bagwell versus Horseshoe.
Thankfully, no Horseshoe.
No Horseshoe. I will, however, show Horseshoe just for anyone who has never seen Horseshoe before.
Oh.
Get uncomfortable, folks. That is Horseshoe. Drink it in.
He always wins.
We fixed that a little bit. We dropped his ranking. He doesn't win all the
time
anymore.
He still always wins.
LOL, Horseshoe wins.
So mad.
Horseshoe wins.
He's
well.
Our Tanahashi, I guess. All right, we got Tom Zenk taking on former Prince Iaukea, now known as Cancer. That's a thing. He's a member of the Signs of the Zodiac, along with Aquarius and Pisces. Very sad backstory in all of that, but I do have it on good authority. I got some word coming in from my sources. I think that's where Stagger Blake Marshall is right now, getting some important information on the road report. Some news is coming in from the WCW Hammer Van, and hopefully he'll be back with some information on that. But some word is getting in. And it's involving the man once known as Prince Iaukea. But nonetheless, show must go on. And we currently have Cancer versus Tom Zenk, the Z-Man, in a G1 900-909-9900 match. This is what we're doing, guys.
You're starting to sound disappointed in yourself.
No, I'm not. I'm actually enjoying the hell out of this. It's taking a little more time than I wanted it to. Oh my god, Zankception. Jesus. That upper left hand corner one is frightening. Look at his thighs. God. His thighs are massive.
I'm calling the Z-Man for nothing, Brian.
Tom Zenk is our Yujiro. That's an insult to Tom Zenk, I think.
Every on his side is the end man. Tom Zenk.
And let's go ahead and... I don't know why this music is still the Prince Iaukea music. Alright, we don't have time for this. Alright, here you go. People are saying, beat Cancer. See, people are cheering on Tom Zenk to beat Cancer. He is the cure for cancer. Well, I just got a word.
This is interesting news. I don't even know if Cancer, formerly known as Prince Ikea, is aware of this, but reports coming from the WCW Hammer Van, which of course is kind of a bloodmobile that we have repurposed. It's still being used as a bloodmobile as well. That Prince Ikea, who now wrestles here as Cancer, who once wrestled here as Prince Ikea, sorry, I gotta get the wording right, is officially in remission. He is cured. Like there are no traces anymore.
Oh, that's wonderful.
That is huge news. As he is entering the G1 900, he is in fact cancer free. No word whether or not he will be. I don't know. Does he go back to Prince Ikea? Is he just known as cancer free now? Does he even know? I don't know.
I'm more stunned that the Hammer Van's what cured him.
Well, that's where the news came from. I don't know if the Hammer Van cured him himself. I don't know if the WCW Hammer Van has healing properties.
You know what? I always thought the Hammer Van had the karaoke machine inside of it.
It does, actually. It does. It's also... It doubles... It used to be one of those EKG machines, but Van Hammer repurposed it into a karaoke machine.
Oh, Lord.
That's brilliant.
Is anyone else? Oh my god, they want to call him the cure. He's the cure. He is now the cure. That is it. And we're going to make him a breath like Robert Smith.
Please do.
Oh my god. He is now the cure. Oh my god.
Boys, don't cry, because crying's for wimps. I had cancer.
This works. I'll go a little inside baseball here. We have something planned. We wanted to announce that when we had a good amount of numbers, and we definitely did tonight. We did not expect to call him the cure, but NTQ, we talked about what we're going to do with this. I think that name works.
Yes.
You hear that sound? That is the sound of anticipation of an angle that we're going to be doing. So.
Perfect.
He will be the cure. I'm going to have to update the wiki now. The Cure Prince Ikea. Was his name Curtis Ikea as well? Did they give him a name
that
in?
That was his gimmick, like ancestor.
He was right. Well, I know he was gimmicked to be like related to King Curtis Ikea. Did he have like a name? Was he Prince something Ikea?
He was just Prince.
He was just Prince.
I thought it was Prince Ikea.
Kind of like how Prince could be a first name, I guess.
Let's see.
Well, I gotta say, giving him a different 80s artist gimmick also works. Get the clamps. Once you see what we're gonna be doing with the Cure Prince Ikea, I don't know if you're gonna. No one's seeing it coming. I'll say that first off. But the name will work very, very well. But you know, again, it's amazing. This guy is wrestling in this match, unaware. Unaware. That he is now cancer free. This is amazing. I'm kind of at a loss for words. This is huge news.
This is definitely probably the best news that could come out of tonight.
Yes, this is wonderful. I mean, you know, this is not part of the entertainment, because we won't want anything that we do to be confused for entertaining. But this is a huge bit of news.
Let's not use the word wonderful. He is still kind of an asshole.
Oh, no, but you know, you don't wish this on any person. So I mean, I think we could take a moment and just kind of put that all aside and be happy for the man. And I'm sure he's going to be ecstatic. I'm sure he's going to be ecstatic once he gets the news. By the way, he almost had a 3 count there, 2 count. About the halfway point in this match, this G1 900 match. A lot of numbers. Goes to the top rope. Oh! Lands the headbutt. I guess there's your Kokeshi. Cover. 1, 2, 3. Well, he's got the win. He's done it. And that is the look of a man. That right there, folks,
is a man.
The pure Prince Iakea. This is, oh my god. This is a huge moment in WCW Universe mode.
I mean, it's not often we have game-changing moments happen, but tonight has changed the game.
Anytime I need to update the wiki page and make adjustments to a cut is a big moment. All right, Fire and LOL, Fire and Ice win. Seriously, like, I don't remember the last time they lost. Main event, Block A, G1, 909-9900. BK Wall Street taking on Bobby Eaton.
Come on, Bobby.
You guys. The people love Bobby. The people love Bobby.
Oh, I like both man, these guys. Man.
Someone has to.
He's just going to like the potatoes.
He is. He's going to try to deep fry them.
Hey, V, when you're done, bring them to me.
Can I have some? Everything tastes so good.
Give me all the ham.
What you heard was, give me a lot of ham. What I meant was, bring me all the ham.
I want all the ham.
I want you all of it. It tastes so good in my mouth. I want to have ham soda.
Have you guys seen that Saturday Live sketch where they had John Hamm as Ham and Bubbly?
What a wonderful idea for a restaurant.
I was at a party and he was kind of drunk.
He came over. He's holding me captive.
There
he won't
go.
Let
There's
me go.
I want all the ham.
Oh, that's so good.
No, we need a new warrior. That's a little known fact. Bobby Eaton was supposed to be our new futuristic warrior against the Lizard Uprising. But because he decided to commit ham suicide, we need a new warrior. I appreciate that, like, we can make Pat Mazzolt references and most of the chat will get it. That means we are approaching the right type of sense of humor.
There he goes, kids. There goes Fuck Squatch.
Character actors, who cares if we're fat?
And for some reason, BK Wall Street is slowly sauntering out to the Renegades music.
We really need to fire the sound guy, Brian.
Come to the Galaxy Multiplex, where the glam pro Hollywood gets peed on nightly.
Hey, a sound guy's still better than most of the guys on the indies.
That's fair.
Shoot me. Who is our Mark Madden? I don't know.
I know who it is, but I'm not going to say it.
Say it. Just say it.
Just say it. You got to say it now.
Say it.
No, I don't.
Say it.
Yeah, well, go ahead and say it.
Because you're the Mark Madden.
One member of the Blue Cheese, a former member of the Blue Cheese Bloods.
Fuck off.
Sorry, Pascal, I didn't know you were the one to pick the Bloods. Come on, I'm gonna click it first. Shoot me.
Well, how am I supposed to know where you're clicking it?
Yes, we made him very fat. I love that the jacket just makes it even fatter. He's wearing one of those sumo suits.
Bobby Eaton starred in the music video for Fat Lit by Sum 41.
Oh my god. He's gonna be looking for one of his finishers, the Diners, Drive-Ins, and Diving Headbutts.
The Flapjack.
A flapjack. A stack of flapjacks. Oh my god. I might have to go in and give him all these moves now. God damn it. That's work.
I don't think it was Fat Lip. What was the mid, like, late 90s, early 2000s music video that had sumo wrestlers in it? Might have been a Weezer video.
Hash Pipe.
It was Hash Pipe.
There you go.
Wheelhouse.
Hash Brown
folks.
Pipes for him.
Hashtag Wheelhouse. Wheelhouse.
Nice.
That's pretty much that entire song.
The dogs. The dogs did the song.
Hobby looks hungry, but luckily VK's bringing all the potatoes.
I do love that. Diners, Drives, and Suicide Dives, yeah. What a fat, the fatness.
Red equals green for BK Wall Street.
Superplex.
It was awesome.
Soup line.
I was gonna say if you're saying it the other way, it's the souffle.
It's a nice souffle.
Wall Street currently just beating the fuck out of Bobby Eaton. Jesus. Drop toe hold! Is there any way I can make that funny? Drop toe hold the mayo. He wouldn't
well,
want you to hold
we'll
the
mayo.
Yeah,
second.
Bobby Eaton would not hold the mayo. What am I talking about?
Yeah. I just want it. Just smear it in this on this Q-tip and just throw it in there.
This is a callback and a food pun at the same time. Craven spots?
Oh, God.
I mean, if anything, he'd be holding the vest. That stupid. I love the watermelon kid picture. It gets me every time. I can't stop looking at it.
I just want a sizzler. A montage of Sizzler restaurant to be set somewhere in Rock America.
Bobby Eaton's gonna do the Hard Times promo, but instead when he's reaching his hand out, he's reaching into the fridge.
Is he gonna stick it halfway through it too?
Oh my God. Wall Street choking him now on the apron. Referee has giving him a 10 count.
Bobby Eaton would do the cold blooded sausage maker, but midway through just get hungry for actual sausage.
Yeah, see, this is why we couldn't do anything else with Bobby Eaton just yet, because the fat puns were still going. And, Wall Street having trouble getting the arms out, locking in the full Nelson around the sheer girth of Bobby Eaton. The arm fat was in the way. And again, this time Bobby Eaton wearing his trunks that are adorned with fruit by the foot.
Oh, nice. He got the endorsement deal.
No, he was just eating it beforehand. And didn't want to throw it away. He wasn't done and didn't want to throw it away. Ah, there's the picture.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. Oh, Falcon. Hard times is when the ketchup won't come out of the bottle no matter how hard you tap. Oh, God. I like where this is going. Oh, my God.
Hey, baby, when you're so fat that you're confined to your bed and you can't get up at night, the view never changes. The view never changes. The view never changes.
Hard time. Hard time is with the competitive eaters of this area.
Area?
The competitive eaters of this country give 35 years to Major League Eaton, and they get a kick in the butt and a watch and say, a computer took your job.
I want to be your partner, baby. And I don't need a handshake. I just want a trip to Sonic to seal the deal, baby. Yeah,
I don't need a handshake. I just need...
A milkshake, baby.
Yeah. I don't need a handshake. I just need a milkshake, baby.
He got a creamsicle! A creamsicle! Where did you snap from?
Oh, there you go. I just need a hug and a Hershey's kiss.
Oh, son of a bitch.
What time is when you want breakfast, but it's 2 p.m., Daddy. Oh, my God. Bobby Eaton has definitely dined on pork and beans.
Hot times, baby. Hot times, baby.
Oh, my God. Falcon is killing it in the chat.
Hot times is when your manager, the manager of a local establishment, comes over and said, all you can eat does not apply to you, sir. That's hot time.
I don't think anyone actually said they wanted to kill him off necessarily, but like they had like, they were like, oh, this should happen. It was like in the, we were talking about stuff. I was like, no. He's got, much like the cheese that he would eat, he must stand alone.
So Bobby Eaton's going to be the American cream now.
Oh, God.
He's just a statistically common man.
Oh, my God. This is... I don't know. This might kill me before congestive heart failure kills Bobby.
Get your ulcers and all your sipper cup full of gravy.
Oh, my God. And Bobby Eaton gets the win. I don't know what his finisher was. But I was busy laughing.
It was a swinging neckbreaker.
Oh my!
So the swinging neck bow.
Swinging.
Charles Robinson just suggested for him to go on the diet.
Oh my God! The chicken neckbreaker. You dropped the elbow macaroni. I love all this. This is wonderful.
Yeah, we got it. We got to hitch all the horses to Bobby Eaton. He's the best thing to come out of WWE Universe for a long time.
Seriously. Oh my God.
Hope he doesn't beat the horses.
Oh my God. Okay. Well then, we're gonna remove this remarkable mat. Actually, let me find out when the Barbarian faces. It's a remarkable match, so it's gonna be weird shit happening. No, we're gonna go ahead and do the G1909-9900. We'll just delay it until it freaking happens. So we'll continue on to night three of it, but this is the second round for Block B. And our first match does in fact feature Wrath. Wrath, who is currently on 2 points. He takes on Evan Courageous of 3 Count, which means we're gonna hear that damn music again. Actually, no, we're not. We're just gonna skip the intro. But you guys can just hum it to yourself. It's fine. Oh, there he is. And again, Wrath on currently on 2 points. What's going on with like the? There we go. My cap car was making some weird like crackly noises. Guys still with me for this one?
Yes.
Alright. Oh, man. Well, Bobby Eaton currently has... He currently has 2 points. We're gonna go ahead and go over Block B as well. Currently on 2 points, Jerry Flynn, Steve Mongo McMichael, and Wrath. No matches between... So on this card, we've got Wrath versus Evan Courageous, Lash LaRue versus Jerry Flynn, and Better Call Damien taking on the Hollywood Barbarian. And that will be our Block B matches. And on a bye week right now is Steve Mongo McMichael on 2 points. So Jerry Flynn and Wrath both have 2. They no one with 2 facing each other, but Damien and Barbarian both have 0. And of course, after that, we will go to Block A. Oh, we have Hardcore Thunder first, but I don't know how far we're going to go into that. Might do Hardcore Thunder and then end it, or we'll play it by ear. See what time it is when we end it. How about you? I'm still having fun.
A hard-hitting night so far, Brian.
It is. Well, you know, I think it's a special occasion. We gotta celebrate Bobby Eaton will eat that world title. That's true. We got to celebrate the fact that the Wonderful New Legacy did great things, raised $10,000 plus more of that. Even enough to cover Sidney Bacabella's mobile phone bill that he's going to pass on the charges to them. For the Canadian Cancer Society through Fighting Back. I don't know, did anyone get any reports from the C4 show? I heard they raised over 20, was it 25 grand? Or close to 25 grand? Hopefully someone in the chat can tell me.
I think it was more.
More than that? I believe it. I'm just going off of what I think I remember from like a tweet that I read. I could even do 24,000. Okay, awesome. Thank you, bud. Oh, damn it. I gotta read it. I gotta read Blake Hedden's thing. Bobby Eaton is into fitness. Fitness whole pizza into his mouth. I should not have laughed at that. That is terrible, and it made me laugh like an idiot.
I'm imagining just sitting backstage with his feet up on a table of catering.
He should with that line. That's a great line. Uno was announced as the big dog. Dos as the wildcat. That's wonderful. This is all great. They did amazing work. Great job. So this is kind of just this is a bit of a celebration. It's a celebration, bitches. It's kind of perfectly tied with the G1 900 as well. G1 ending this morning, so a new one starting up. In fact, I'd say if there's just the G1, and we're 1-900-909-900, that's like, commas, 19 billion times better. Math.
It's legit.
Yeah, I mean, it's science.
Yeah.
So it's so legit that it won't fit.
It's too legit.
I should write a song about that.
We will call it Adam's Family Groove.
Really? Really, Johnny?
Yeah.
All Bacabella did to me was send me a bill. Apparently he does not, in fact, work for free.
It's a Bacabella.
No, it's not.
No, it's not.
I made that up.
That's a relief.
It's actually a please leave.
I want you to stick your head in a window and call a friend over and then just have them slam it over and over again.
Yeah, stay in there. Stay in that window. By the way, Wrath hit the cannonball on Evan Courageous.
Melissa Etheridge that shit.
Okay, get
it. Or more appropriately from the Tears in Heaven joke, Eric Clapton that shit.
Thank you.
Would you know my name if I
coming to the stage!
Coming up next.
No, you weren't playing Quiplash. Were you there for that joke, Ben?
I don't know.
It was Foster. Foster won Quiplash. Well, he didn't. I don't know if he won the game, but he basically.
No, I actually didn't even win that question.
You didn't win that question?
No, you definitely.
You had to have.
No, you won that question. You got a Quiplash on it because you beat me.
Oh, that's right.
But you won that stream by. For those who are not familiar, we played Quiplash. The question was. The worst song to do a strip tease to, and Foster's answer was Tears in Heaven. And that is the. And a good laugh was had by all.
I think that I never thought about it, but there's an ongoing conversation with me and Dags, who's my friend, who's a real person, I swear. The worst songs to have sex to question, and I think Tears in Heaven just jumped to number one.
Oh, yeah.
Because for a while there, we always had Cats in the Cradle.
Oh, God. Or Seasons in the Sun.
Cats in the Cradle and Seasons of the Sun are up there, and like any Sarah McLachlan song is terrible.
Really, Wrath is a house of fire. He is going nuts.
Michael Elgin.
Fighting Spirit by Courageous. He just kept up and said, "Fuck your shit."
Courageous living up to his last name.
He just moved him into Charles Robinson. Robinson just didn't give a fuck. Oh, we'll be cushioned by Courageous. Duck under. Springboard splash. Bulldog. Courageous House of Fire! This is totally like a Japanese wrestling match. Everyone's hitting a bunch of spots and then no-selling for the other guy.
Oh my god, this is insane.
Gary Stridham.
Wow!
Gary Stridham is just wonderful. This is just... We one time, like a bunch of us watched that show. Because apparently that entire show is somewhere on the internet. And we watched it. And it's terrible.
So bad.
We tapped out before we got to Gary Stridham. Wrath with the cover.
Yeah, I think we tapped out with
Wrath
with Giant Killer. I can't remember what his real name was, but he was like 5'4". And everybody had a theme. His theme was that he was.
They would gimmick everyone up. Yeah.
And just like, oh god.
Wrath up to 4 points.
Wrath has 4 points. This is huge. 2-0. Two wins from two matches. He's got to be an early favorite, but you know that can be a lot of. Oh god. Didn't one guy come out with a gun? He probably did. That sounds right.
Man, he's got a gun!
That is true. Gary's Tridem is roughly is much funnier when you think his name is Gary's Tridem. Thank you. NTQ. Alright, our next match. Roadblock versus Cyclope. Nope. Match between Lash LaRue and Jerry Flynn. And with Jerry Flynn on 2 points, Lash LaRue on zero, this is a more important match than I think we originally would have guessed. I mean, all these matches are important. You only get six matches. You don't get a lot of room for error here. It's not like those boys out in the Orient. Not as racist when I call it the Orient as an area. I think it's when I refer to people as Oriental. That's when
it's
racist.
Nope,
right?
Still just as racist.
Okay, cool. Well, but WCW would say that, right?
Probably.
Is it true to WCW? Okay, those boys out in the Far East would have, 11 guys in each block where you could lose a match or two and it wouldn't matter because you still got like 10 or 9 more. I got nothing.
WCW would just call them Chinamen.
They would just call them all Chinamen, you're right.
Jesus.
You're absolutely right. Whoever said that.
NTQ.
Oh my god, that's so wrong. Second match with these two, Lash LaRue, Jerry Flynn. Lash LaRue, Bulldog, he lost his first match to Mongo. Jerry Flynn got a win over Better Call Damien. I say both those may kind of seem like a little bit of upsets. I think people were expecting Better Call Damien to get the win. Lash LaRue was pegged as a favorite by a couple. Oh, and those martial arts kicks by Jerry Flynn. Clearly he learned those in the Frontier Martial Arts Wrestling Organization. I mean, martial arts is in the name, right? It's got to be it. I don't know.
Well, yeah, of course.
Has anything fallen further than the new FMW? Like, has anyone, like, paid attention to...
There's a new FMW?
Yeah, they brought it back.
Oh, Jesus.
It's pretty sad when you look at the cards. Like, I recognize so few of the names, and the ones I do, it's like,
Yeah, it's really weird they're having Hayabusa main event, too.
It is weird. No, but you laugh, but Onita is still main eventing.
I'll Pearl Harbor you.
Yeah.
I want Onita. Oh, god damn it, I'm
Jap
the fucker.
Son of a bitch, Onita.
Oh, I'm going to be so bummed when he's...
He's not going to die. Terry Funk will never die.
Every time you think he's going to die, he's going to come back.
Yes. All he has to do is just keep announcing that he will, and then he'll keep coming back.
I saw my father, and I saw... That's a jackass. Well, that's no jackass. It was just Ric Flair.
They brought back FMW. Yeah, they brought back FMW, but it's under some weird other name. Like, it's FMW is part of the title, but it's got a bunch of other, like, words to it. I don't remember exactly how it's pronounced, what it is. But, like, the cards are kind of sad. They're not anyone really recognized. They do, like, one death match a show, if that. I mean, FMW, when it was going, was ridiculous. In fact, I kind of want to go find some FMW shows and watch them if it's slow at work tomorrow. So if anyone has any links and would like to tweet them to the IRM stream Twitter, that'd be delightful. If you have any full FMW shows, that would be good to watch. I'd be happy for that. And of course, thank you all for joining us. And please, the social medias are all below if you haven't already. I try to keep the schedule pretty up to date. I'll be updating the new week tomorrow, hopefully, if I have some spare time at work. At home and not doing this thing at my job. That would be crazy.
Yeah, what kind of weirdos work on their stuff in their jobs?
What was that?
Nothing.
No, I didn't hear it. You actually didn't hear it. The sad thing is I actually didn't hear what you said.
Oh, I said what kind of weirdos work on projects at their job instead of doing their job?
Yeah, right?
Yeah, what kind of idiots text each other about ideas?
I honestly would not have time to do most of the shit that I do regarding this channel if I didn't, like, take some time at work during, like, my slow period to, like, do things like make graphics. Jerry Flynn gets the win! Jerry Flynn and Wrath are both on 4 points. And the referee checking on Jerry Flynn.
I thought I'd say that about Jerry Flynn, but that's my pick right there.
It is. Duel is looking very smart with his pick of Jerry Flynn.
Agree or disagree, Ray Stevens is the voice of our generation.
I don't know what to say about.
Shut up.
The guy was
the that's why they call the Will the Streak.
I knew you were going for that. Shut up.
By the way, just another music
video.
That
was very fast. Yeah, that was 3:19. That was the shortest match in the G1 900 so far. Blake will be happy because Roblox is getting bumped. And we've got our third G1 900 match from night 2 of Block B. A lot of qualifiers, but whatever.
And just so everybody knows, Ray Stevens, the guy who sang the streak, now sings right-wing political song parodies.
Wait,
so
I did not know that.
America, right?
He does America, yep. He's no Kinky Friedman.
Yeah, motherfucker ain't no Weird Al. Kinky Friedman's amazing.
Is he?
Yeah.
Like, Imus used to play him all the time.
Kinky Friedman played the Ballad of Charles Whitmore, which is the guy sitting up there on the Texas Tower.
Blake, I might have to do. I don't know. Is Vader? I don't think Vader's in this game, is he? Oh no, he is. God, he's right
there.
He is. Never mind. I see him front and center, screaming. That might have to be something that happens off, not part of universe mode. But oh my God, that might have to be someone we bring in for the final. That might be fun, cause like it's the G1 final, so they bring in all these random ass people for it. So why not? We'll do some silly thing for that one.
I mean, this is the if you're gonna bring in, like, actual name WCW guys that you don't have cause of, this is the game to do it. There's a ton of them.
That's true.
You get, like, Ray, Arn Anderson, the Road Warriors, Ricky Steamboat.
I might do that just for, like, silly. Just for the silly.
Shut up!
Because you know how, like, because, like I said, you know, it's like, the G1 will bring it, like, they'll bring in random people for, like, the finals. Like, it'll have all the super show. We'll totally do somebody versus Vader. Why not?
Kevin Nash.
Oh, that's right, we got Nash. Oh my God, yeah, we'll have to do that. And Cyclope, oh my God, Cyclope. Sorry, Cyclope just brained the Hollywood Barbarian. Well, I don't know what the make is. We still got a match. This is very complicated because Cyclope has got some history with Better Call Damien.
Cyclope was actually booked on the show.
Okay, he's doing his taunt or whatever. I don't know.
Cyclope was booked on the show, but still got a front row ticket just cause.
He's booked after Wrath took out the Hollywood Barbarian in the first match. He has taken out the Hollywood Barbarian. He's got it in for that man. I don't know what to make of this. Better Call Damien. Atomic drop. Well, I mean, you know, you can't fault Better Call Damien for taking advantage of this. I mean, it's a tournament. There's a lot at stake. You can't take pity on your opponent because you got attacked. The match must still go on, and the Hollywood Barbarian with a press slam doesn't seem to be showing too much of the effects of it. Cyclope lines up with Wrath, which is weird. He's his legal representation. And we know there's been a bit of a feud between him and Cyclope and Better Call Damien, so this is all very interesting. Not sure when Better Call Damien takes on Wrath, but you better believe that'll have some implications. It also just goes to show lawyers can't be trusted. It also goes to show this game likes fucking with me. Ah, Brain Buster! And Barbarian going for the headbutt, missing. again, both Wrath and Jerry Flynn on 4 points.
I like it. This is good so far. This is like kind of how the G1 works. This is good. People start taking the lead. This is good. And of course, everyone's going to end with 3-3.
Yeah.
At the end of it. And I'm going to have to just, like, give it to Hogan.
Battle Royal.
Give it to Roadblock. Oh, big running kick by the Barbarian. Oh, the chops. We're going strong style on this one.
Both men seem to be targeting the neck area of each other.
Yes, and just like that, and working that neck, Barbarian wrenching the leg.
God damn it. What a sound.
I love your timing. The timing, I was watching, as you were saying that, I was like, I knew you were delayed. I was watching it happen, I was like, yep.
Well, he just hit a DDT, so naturally he's probably going to go for like a kidney shot next. God damn it, he's stomping the kidneys.
The kid with the watermelon? Okay, that kid with that gift, that gift of the kid with the watermelon, it looks like his soda explodes. Like every time, look at it, it looks like his soda explodes.
Like, that's it looks like he's maybe never had.
Maybe there's like a mass shooting in that scissor, and that's why he's looking frightened.
Why is there a lot of white people there?
Tots, not cool.
I apologize to white people.
Hey, all sizzlers matter.
No, it's
it. The GIF captures the shitty transition they did from one blissful customer to another.
Yes.
So it's like a child looks like he's never eaten watermelon.
That poor child never had watermelon before.
That is my favorite.
Give me some of that watermelon. I had watermelon before.
I like the watermelon gift, but nothing beats the Shane McMahon try move.
You're right. That drink does need some ice cubes. What is that from? Shane looks like hell in that. He looks like he got stung by a lot of bees.
I want to say Trimoon edited that to like warp his face.
I'm guessing so. It's got to be a Trimoon, right? That is a Trimoon. Okay, yeah. So he does look all puffy for a reason.
Ice cubes.
Shane's been hanging out with Bobby Eaton.
Oh God! Oh God!
She's your lady.
Sizzler is America. America's place to eat. I bet that's not too far off from what it sounds like. Except there's a sax solo in the middle. I haven't watched that in forever.
You said we're going to Sizzler, Sidney.
The damn Sizzler thing. Why is this a thing?
It's infomercial.
What? Why is this?
Hey.
The things that come up in these streams are just the strangest. Well, anyway, I do hope... Oh, good. Oh, Chase. Don't just that's amazing. Oh god. Chase is actually asking if we only do wrestling. No, we do some wrestling. We know that a lot of folks who watch us are wrestling fans, so we do a lot of wrestling, but we do a lot of other stuff too. Our main stuff is HCL and Kumite. They're a simulated MMA kind of parody fed. So we do those twice a month. You can check all that on the YouTube and in our video section. We just had a Kumite show on Thursday, and the Hollywood Barbarian gets the win. He is now on 2 points. Gets that first win.
And Kumite and MMA are like cough eds, but I guess.
Yeah, they're basically like cough eds, but for MMA games. HCL is our UFC. Kumite is our Pride.
It's more like. I guess compared to people that would be more familiar, it's more like Hogan versus Flair than like Over the Edge. It's not like a realistic simulation.
Oh yeah, it's not for real. Yeah, it's like all silly, and we do live commentary over it. It's pre-produced with graphics and stuff, and then we just do live commentary over the HCL, and we record it. We also do a soccer league called the League of Atrocities. Prison Soccer. That's mostly on YouTube, but occasionally we'll air live commentary matches because those are a bit much to do. Yeah, awesome. Cool. Thanks for following the channel. Yeah, I mean, you know, we do a lot of different stuff. Most of the stuff we do involves just kind of like simulating stuff and just seeing what happens. We do a lot of fun stuff. We play like interactive games. You know, this is interactive in the sense that we like people to tell us who is wrestling in some things. For example, it's Hardcore Thunder, guys. And,
Hardcore Thunder!
In fact, I would like to know, Matthew Foster,
yes,
who
sir.
Is the first opponent of Das Hardcore King, Alex
I
Wright?
Hate myself for having to suggest this. You have no idea how angry I am at myself that I have to suggest this. But because
I do have veto power, I do have veto and address power, but go ahead.
Because we talked him up so much, I think we have to do Horseshoe.
No.
No.
No, thank you, Brian.
What do you want? Hold on. What do you want?
Horseshoe.
No.
No, it's okay. I didn't really want a Horseshoe. I just always been talked up to the point where...
No.
Like, we have to...
Horseshoe is a... Ooh. Is a feature attraction.
I'm sorry, I just saw on ESPN2, the World Arm Wrestling League is on.
Oh my god, I'm putting it
Scott
on in the
Norton.
Background.
Scott Norton. That's a
Stop
sign.
Stop drilling
Scott
you,
Norton.
Struck oil.
So many sleeveless shirts. Pasco, you love it there.
It's amazing. Who do people want in the chat? I'm going to go to the chat then. Awesome, yeah, you're a big New York City. Yeah, we do wrestling stuff because... you know, all our main stuff is in the description below, all the main stuff we do. Like, WCW Universe Mode gets a lot of people, and then people love it, so we do that a lot. HCL and Kumite, love that. Those are fun. I think you should totally check those out. Those are each once a month. LOA, that's a lot on YouTube. That's just, again, simulated soccer. Once a month on a Sunday night, we will all watch an old pay-per-view together on the network or elsewhere on the network. People want Scott Norton. All right. Or, as we're calling him, White Ice Chain.
Scott Norton.
Shh. Scott Norton won the over-the-top arm wrestling tournament.
He did, in honor of the arm wrestling thing.
I listened to his episode of Art of Wrestling today. Scott Norton's team best dude.
Is he really? Is he good?
Yeah, dude? He's always been a good... Yeah, he's a good dude. I like Daniel Bryan and Rocky Romero. I love him because he was just always...
Hear.
He was just like, I like everybody.
People are losing their minds over this arm wrestling thing.
Which, have you ever seen the documentary Pulling John?
Someone's asking, why is this on WWE 12 and not 14 at least? Because I originally, we started this when WWE 12 was the most recent game. And that's like telling Caveman to do Hogan versus Flair with a new game. So, no, all the saves are here. I'm not going to go look for all these guys. We've got all the stuff already established. So, that's why it's on the screen. Because we started this a long time ago. The YouTube... God, it's loud. Jesus. The YouTube streams and us being on Hitbox are only recently because I'm a dummy and never moved them all to YouTube in the past. And same with the wiki page. I'm trying to keep track of everything, including title history. Which is going to be tough with the hardcore weight title, because it's changing all the damn time. But, oh my god. Oh my god. Did you add it to the shut up tube thing? Oh, I'm going to have to grab them and copy and paste them. I don't think I can get the time at work, but oh my god, that's a problem. By the way, they're showing the middleweight left-hand division in arm wrestling. That is a thing that is on a sports network that everybody has. Meanwhile, we have Scott Flash Norton taking on Alex Wright against Alex Wright would like to dedicate this match to his Führer.
Falco.
That's true, yeah. And that's the thing and also people are asking, do you have this guy? Are you gonna bring this guy in? Sadly the servers are all down. All these guys were either downloaded or someone made one. Dual made Roadblock, which I'm forever thankful for, and Blake will not be happy about. Will made Hard Work Bobby Walker.
because there wasn't one. Fitz made the Vianos. I made Ice Train by taking Scott Norton and making him black. You can totally see it when you see them standing together as a tag team. It's really funny. I need to go get some water, so if you guys can just hold on the fort for me.
I wouldn't say anything while he's gone.
Obviously, there's a lot of love that goes into this as well. I'll try with a big DDT. This is a fun thing for all of us.
Yeah. Got any ketchup to go with that schmaltz? What?
What?
I mean, what? What the fuck was that? Who was that guy that just came in here? Oh, that's my twin brother, Steve Pascoe.
Ben, are you okay?
No, I'm never okay.
Is he cooler than you at least?
Who are saying Mike tonight is the fuel?
What?
At Alex Wright's celebration party last week to celebrate going through the whole night of Hardcore Thunder, 99 Luff balloons were dropped from the ceiling.
Nice.
Very low-key attendant party.
Low-key was there, you're right.
Yes, he asked. Alex Wright asked if he wanted to dance. He said no.
Alex, low-key was just standing in the corner not taking pictures with people. How's that for a callback to like an hour ago?
You become too self-aware.
I know.
Loki, how are you? No.
I love how if you watch arm wrestling right now, it's like all dads.
It's like, yes.
My favorite part, and yes, I've watched arm wrestling on ESPN before, but it's just... Look at the faces these guys are making. This is insane. My favorite is when they try to do it normally, and then like the hands keep slipping or there's disputes, and then the referee holds the strap up and the place goes nuts and they have to strap their arms together.
How long does it usually take the new 2Ks to get to PC?
I don't know.
Because
it's about 6 months.
About 6 months? Because I have
the last one. Yeah.
Because I have this one-off idea I want to do one time if I ever have. It requires a lot of work, and that is Tournament of Dad.
Oh God.
Which is just TV dads in a series of hardcore matches to determine the ultimate television father.
Before we get too off the topic of like the televised arm wrestling, I'm imagining when the ref calls for the strap, there's like people in the crowd that have signs that said we came here to see the strap or something stupid like that.
The thing that's always crazy is they're always like almost hitting each other in the face because they're pulling their hands.
Yeah, it's so weird. I sit down and they keep sliding out. And they get like all really upset and they start like disputing. Oh, they went for the strap. They got the strap.
Woo, the strap. We get to see the
strap. Yabba pie.
Look at Brad Maddox back there going crazy over it.
Oh my god.
Seriously. What's his name?
There's been a lot of arm wrestling.
Yeah, I don't know what his name is. Oh my god. And he just starts screaming in the guy's face when he wins. Jeez, that guy's gonna...
Ridley got huge.
Dad Maddox.
That guy is gonna murder somebody.
Also, there's a British guy. Of course, there's a British guy.
This is absolutely crucial.
I gotta tell you, the sleeves to arm ratio in this room that is televised in is at an all-time low.
No, I'm not watching it either.
Okay, holy crap, chant started in the match. Alex Wright has a crutch.
I'm picturing Tom Hardy. British guy.
Blake Haddon, don't you worry. M. Dickey Game is going to be coming to IRM. I think I can't really keep it secret, MDK, because like
you've
already mentioned it before.
Yeah.
It's going to be... Like how they're just standing around for a while, and then Scott Horn just brains him with a chair and does a dance.
I mean, isn't that how you greet people?
Mm-hmm. But the, It's not going to be starting anytime soon because it's going to take a little bit of time to create everybody and to get it right. I'm not familiar with the game too much, so I got to learn how to use it.
Contract negotiations.
But we're going to be doing, with the M. Dickey Game, we're going to be doing Irresponsible Wrestling from Florida. The hottest new deathmatch shindy. And I will be hiring, I am looking to hire... the best commentary team
in the southeastern panhandle of Florida.
I might know a guy.
I think
I know a guy too, but he wants to know why the shows are can't pray in school.
I'm teasing. The commentary is gonna be a lot of us doing it. It's gonna be mostly on YouTube. A couple of shows a year will be on Hitbox, our bigger ones. Wow, Alex Wright just sold that guitar in the worst way possible. He he got hit by it. He delayed and then he slowly slumped to his knees.
The fear flop.
Fear flop.
Alex Wright knows he just has to hang on for another 3.5 minutes.
Oh my god, his Fuhrer is gonna be Rick Fuhrer. Das Nature Boy.
Oh yeah.
Oh my god. Oh, power bombs and float over. We got a new champion! Scott Norton!
I think it's gonna be hard to fucking beat.
The boyhood dream has come true for Scott Norton.
For the fifth time.
I don't know why Raph was.
He's excited for Scott Norton winning. He just wants to show his congratulations.
I hope you arm wrestling fans are happy. So now, here's the problem. Scott Norton has to defend this. I don't care if that's a remarkable match. It's never happening. Because this is Hardcore Thunder. I wonder, have people made YouTube poops of the Sizzler ad? I feel like they should have at this point. Well, Scott Norton is a double champion now. He is one half of the tag team champion. And we need an opponent. No, we need two opponents. All right, we got Rocco Rock. High Voltage. So, and I know someone said Kenny Chaos earlier of the High Voltage, so I'm going to go ahead and do Kenny Chaos and Flyboy Rocco Rock. Where's Kenny Chaos in this? I know. Oh, there he is.
Now, Rocco Rock was Ted Petty, right?
Yes, he was.
He loved having parties. He always loved sending out invitationals. Mm-hmm.
No.
It's nice. Like they bring out tables and like clearly, because I mean, you got to put your refreshments on something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Na, na, na. Let's all have fun together. Na 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 na. Na.
I do like it though. This is good. This is like an all like tag team members of tag team. We had a lucha one the first time. Now we got the tag team together. I like it. Remember, we still gonna need. Three more opponents for that next one. Let's see who makes it out alive of Hardcore Thunder.
Nobody.
Nobody eventually. Yeah, eventually.
Everybody's gonna die.
Thank you, Tracy.
You're welcome.
I gotta say, and I kept mentioning this during when I was on for the charity stream they had Jervis on, is that I love that old wrestling is a thing, and I only wish that they did more shows. Because their main event coming up in 2 weeks is Tracy Smothers versus a bear.
It's the best. Yeah,
it's about time. It's the classic.
It's the rematch we've all been
it
waiting.
Is. And I love that the website has a little, like, disclaimer saying, look, it's not a real bear, okay?
Have people seen the original Tracy Smothers versus a bear match?
I don't think I have.
Okay, talk about people I'm going to be bummed about if they ever die. Tracy Smothers is, like, the best fucking dude.
Tracy Smothers has made a good portion of his career out of not bumping and having great matches, though.
Like... See, Tracy Smothers has actually wrestled a bear before. That's why they're doing
That's
it.
Wonderful.
I feel like if more people knew about that video, they would know it should not be on the internet.
Yeah, like, here's the thing. This kind of thing should never, ever happen again. But by God, I'm going to enjoy watching it because it did happen at one point. It's like... I'm trying to think of things you, like, you know are wrong, but you enjoy anyway, but you never want to see them happen again.
Yeah. Oh, mop the face.
So I guess it's like watching a Chris Benoit match. Like, you enjoy it, but you don't want to ever see anybody do that stuff again because you know what it's going to lead to.
Jesus Christ, Will. That's not like
I don't know. I'm trying to think of a good comparison. It's like a weird feeling where you're like, this is amazing.
How about it's like watching a man wrestle a bear?
Shut up. God damn it. Jerk.
Interesting match because like all three of these guys are kind of in the tag team title hunt. Scott Norton, the one half of the tag team champions, High Voltage and the Public Enemy have been two major teams challenging for that title.
Chase says Batista isn't a good one.
Well played. That's like that. Raven, so Raven, what role did you enjoy in wrestling cinema?
Why not?
I'm very excited for the G1 900, 909, 9900 Tag League Climax later this year.
Actually, you joke, but I
was hoping that this was leading to a tag tournament.
I was thinking about it. There are going to be a lot more of these like tournament type things going on. It's going to be just fun. It's not going to be the next thing that's happening, but there is the plans for a tag league in the works.
Do you want to hear my suggestion?
Coast to coast. Chat.
Yep. Oh, type in the chat? Okay.
Yeah. Because I don't want to, like, hear a name and then not use it, or it be something you don't realize that I'm going to use.
Well, just, like,
that.
The concept.
It's going to be a tag league, but, I mean, like... Oh, yeah. No, we're doing both. We've done Lethal Lottery before.
Okay.
We're going to do Lethal Lottery Battle Bowl as well. In fact, maybe Lethal Lottery leads to some good teams from the tag league.
We get teams like Rocco Rock and Robbie Rage. It can be the Alliteration Nation.
Exactly. I hate you for that, but I like it. But yeah, we're gonna have like a bunch of like events like that. Like, there's gonna be the Lethal Lottery, which leads to Battle Bowl, of course. And then after that is going to be the tag league, which will be like 10 teams, two blocks of five. And who knows, maybe some of the tag teams from Lethal Lottery will be showing up. We'll be like, hey, we make a good team.
Teams like,
Oh God, who was the team we set up to win Monarchist Day Six Man, which we are never doing again? We tried to do a King of Trios, and it was the worst thing ever. No, NGQ is saying it perfectly. We set up a team to win, in the very beginning, and they lost first round to a team called the Turds in the Punch Bowl, we named it. It was like Van Hammer, Tom Zank, and someone else. And I remember we ended up having to do the ending match as like a six-way Elimination Chamber match. It was just a wreck.
It was Lash LaRue.
He could be with Robbie Rage and Rocco Rock in the Alliteration Nation. Stable.
Still funny.
Still relevant.
Why are you not calling it the Nation of Alliteration?
Because I like Alliteration Nation better.
Shouldn't it be the Alliteration Alliance, since the name should be alliteration as well?
There's multiple. Ah, I mean, look how many layers this idea has, Brian.
This is so stupid.
It was like past, but you're in assonance. Oh, Lord. Oh, the turbine. I'm kind of glad I don't have records.
Oh, my
anymore.
God, Scott Norton did
anything. Scott Norton is killing everybody, by the way.
I'm going to go back to being scared of everything. Oh, my God, I can't believe you did that. Oh, no, Powerball. Oh, no, Suplex. Oh, jeez.
Like, just like an onion, all of these layers are making me cry. Very good point. Oh my god.
I love finding out that Scott Norton was in the tag team.
Oh, Scott Norton's been eliminated! Kenny Chaos got the win!
That was lame.
I don't even know how it happened!
Yeah, what a body drop!
Danger, high voltage.
You gotta hear that awesome music though.
Fuck the Bobby drop.
Oh, I love when I freeze
what
on
you're gonna, what's gonna happen to you in a 5 minute game?
I think he broke his neck in that match, but he's not looking okay.
Oh, bang Bobby drop.
He looks off. That's what happened when you get dropped on your neck so many times. It's kind of like his neck just kind of, his head just kind of slumps to the side. His neck cannot help his. Oh, God. All right. We're doing it. Everyone in the four-way has to have alliteration. I need some help with this one. So, obviously, we've got.
Lash is in the tournament.
We can't do Lash. Yeah, it's true.
Let's see. I'm going to look at the list.
See who we got.
Johnny B. Bad. Robbie Rage. Rocco Rock.
We already had Rocco Rock. We can't do him again.
How many?
Buff Bagwell.
Ah, there we go. Is he more than one? Oh my god.
Viano 5.
Yes!
I might allow that one. Let's see who we got.
Cyclope.
Cyclope.
Nightclub. Buff Bagwell's Marcus Bagwell.
We don't have as many as I thought we would. Malibu Mang.
We have a lot, just none like that we could put that are.
Some we can't use because they're in the G1. Mongo McMichael's in it. Damn.
Can we put Steven Regal in it? Just to put Steven Regal in it?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Because I just realized I haven't ever seen him on the stream. I was looking at the Wikipedia and I didn't realize that. Why aren't you guys having Steve Regal on all the time?
Seriously, I wonder what kind of. Does he have any other, like.
Is William Regal in the game? Yeah, he is! He's a call and then the actual person.
Yeah. Why would I use the one in the game?
Yeah, that's so silly.
I tried. Someone did want Scotty Riggs and they want Malgus. The people want Horseshoe. I gotta give them. I'm sorry. The people want Horseshoe. For some reason. We'll try.
Can we at least put? Can we at least put somebody we all like really hate to like so that Horseshoe might rape him or something? I don't know.
Wow, Will, that's dark.
Yeah, that one's dark real quick.
I mean.
Yeah, I opened the roster page to try to figure
out Jim
any,
Powers.
Any other dumb tag names I can come up with.
Jim Powers is making the face that he would make if he learned he had a face horseshoe. That Jim Powers reaction face. I'm going to leave it up for a second. That Jim Powers reaction face is wonderful. NTQ, you know what to do.
Jim Powers is not too thrilled about facing Horseshoe.
You could put Tribute Mortis together with Laparca and be the Skeleton Crew.
Oh no, we've got a plan for Tribute Mortis.
Okay.
We're gonna turn Hardcore Bobby Walker into fake Sting.
Right, I kind of know this idea.
I think I told you that. And put him with Tribute Mortis.
Oh man.
Jim Powers is not having anything about that. No, that's not true. Jim Powers' real name is not Jim Jowers.
You could go the
Jim Jowers.
The deepest cut. The deepest cut.
I almost believed it.
The deepest cut would be to make the Men at Work too.
It needs to be Jim Jowers now.
Jim Jowers. Sometimes the simplest idea is the best one.
The real Double J, Jim Jowers. See, I think he was so adamant about wanting Jim's powers in this match that I would have believed that he would know everything about the man. You led me down the wrong path. Alright, Hardcore. Steven Regal not going after a Horseshoe. Got that reverse waist lock. I think he heard Horseshoe moan and had to get rid of him. Jim Jowers. God damn, it's made me laugh for a while. Jim Jowers sounds like someone who's like, was like what Jim Powers would say his name was if he wore a fake mustache and like had to not be detected by somebody. Like he was thrown out of the building and had to like try to sneak back in. No, I'm Jim Jowers.
Oh, Mr. Jowers, come right in. Expect you to sing the national anthem.
Oh boy.
Horseshoe has tasted pee before. That's what we're going with.
It's not a very good experience.
He's had pee before. And a ladder is being introduced to this match by Jim Jowers.
Jim Jowers.
Seriously, and Horseshoe are dropping each other on their heads. And Horseshoe has the ladder. Oh, god damn it! That is one sick son of a bitch! Oh, no, the knee! Oh, right his knee! Jesus Christ! Well, Kenny Chaos setting up the ladder in a strange place. Okay. Suplex by Jowers.
Come on, Jowers. Oh,
blasted him in the face with the chair.
No, not come on, Jowers.
Do you want Horseshoe to win?
Come on, Steven Regal.
There you go.
That sounds like a Homer Simpson character.
It really does. Like I said, it sounds like a name that Jim Powers would use trying to sneak back into an arena.
Like, that's when he checks in the hotels under.
Yeah.
To avoid the mob of fans.
A cover on Regal. One count. I think Horseshoe just wanted to lay on another man.
He'll lay on anything that's a warm body.
Why do they have to give them from behind chat when he's covering somebody?
Yeah, it's funny.
It's so uncomfortable.
Chaos with the cover. Nope. Remember, Chaos just needs to survive.
Rock strong, yeah. That's another suggestion that he had.
What was that?
I think Rock Strongjaw would also be a Homer Simpson name.
Rock Strongjaw, that's right.
Gower's pounding on Horseshoe, Horseshoe enjoying it.
Bomb by Chaos. Cover. And Regal is out. We're down to just Horseshoe, Jim Jowers, and Kenny Chaos.
Plenty of room on the Jowers wagon, Ben.
Fuck up.
It's the Jower Hour.
If you want to keep it alliteration, the Jowers Jalopy.
I think Jim Jowers would be enough. Oh god, he did a neckbreaker on that chair. Christ. Jim Jowers is just throwing that ladder around. Uncomfortable small package. Kick out by Horseshoe. Bomba over the top, that's crazy. Title belt. So, oh god, I just slapped the taste right out of Jim Jowers' mouth.
Guys.
It's canon out there. And
fuck!
Get the cannon.
Covered by Jowers! Jowers pins Horseshoe!
Oh my god.
Well, thank god. You're
down to Kenny George. Chaos.
Well,
and
you know,
Jim Jowers.
You know you have to change his tights.
I don't have to change his tights. I'm gonna leave the tights like that, but I'm gonna go with the name. I gotta give him a mustache. A fake mustache.
His evil twin.
It's his evil twin.
You can clone him and make him his evil twin.
I like that Falcon. What the fuck?
That could be a tag team. Double Double J. Okay, we need to follow Horseshoe for some reason.
What the fuck? Oh my god. He does the Jomaye. Is he really? Oh god. Oh! Face sitter. That's what we're going with.
He's got 2 minutes.
He does have 2 minutes.
Will the clock strike midnight on this Cinderella story?
Nope. No one at the entrance. Oh, God. Kenny Chaos rubbing his face.
Did they edit the match together?
On that title belt for some reason. The J Factor. Of course, the J Factor. Oh, he's got him in the torture rack. Oh, Chaos drops him. He's not done. Oh, Kenny Chaos just has to survive. Gut wrench, power bomb, as opposed to the Jower bomb.
Oh, new finisher too.
Ah, clothesline from the top turns Jowers inside out. Cover. Does he get it? Kenny Chaos retains the belt.
Oh.
And of course,
as is customary in WCW Universe, but whenever something fun and new and exciting happens to a new character, they immediately lose.
High voltage. It's like they're at WCW.
Pretty much. Uh-oh. Nothing's happening, guys. I'm hitting feet. Nothing's happening.
Start making defeat for Jim Gowers. That's right, I teach you.
Unrelated, but apparently tonight at the pro wrestling show, Dalton Castle didn't have his boys, and so Chuck Taylor and Tommaso Ciampa were the replacement boys tonight.
No! No, we didn't injure Jim Jowers. No, this is not right.
God damn it.
No, poor Jim Jowers. He's
fucking
dead.
Fucking Jim Jowers is dead.
Wait a minute. Hold on. I think that Toy Quad is right. Jim Powers is dead. Long
Jim Jowers
Powers.
Is okay.
So he's coming back.
Oh my god. It works with the storyline. Jim Powers is dead. Jim Jowers is fine. Fuck. Oh my god, I don't even know what to say. Other than we got the G1900, we'll finish off with the G1900. Oh my god. Whew. We're gonna start things off. Oh fuck. With Bobby Eaton.
I am going to drop out, guys. Have a good night.
Alright, you have a good one, man.
Thanks.
All of our G1 matches are between people who have 2 points and people who have 0 points. So we have Bobby Eaton on 2 points. 2 points, and those are not Weight Watcher points. He is on a lot more than just those. Taking on a man who did not wrestle, who had his bye in the first week. La Parca! And Triple H is just not approving of this. He is just so disappointed in us.
You got all of these superstars in this game, and you chose these guys.
Decided to put a sombrero on Jimmy Jones.
Jim Powers. We're gonna go back again and pronounce Tim Powers. Just out of respect.
Tim Jowers.
This is where Heenan would say something like, you know, Bobby Eaton. You know, when Bobby Eaton started his match with La Parca had meat on those bones.
Tim Towers. He's just giant.
Yeah.
And there's two of them. Wait for it. Wait for it.
No, I don't want to.
Sorry, John Powell was terrorizing.
I love the concept of this. Oh man, the room's not smart enough to get my 9/11 joke.
What was your joke? I missed it. God, I don't even know what to say at this point. We
don't
will, of course,
at all.
This is we're gonna have the last three matches of the second round of G1900 matches.
It's polar opposites as the biggest man in the world, Bobby Eaton, versus a skeleton.
A man who is reduced to bones.
Damn bones.
Oh my god.
As a matter of fact, when people waste food now, they don't say you could have feed 50 African children. They said you could have feed 50 La Parcas.
Someone get La Parca, damn. Get La Parca, damn sandwich. Body of Dysmorphia Parca.
No, don't get him a damn sandwich. Eaton's going to steal it and eat it.
La Parca should have a sinus sizzle dance for food.
I just want everything. I just want to eat everything. So good.
So, can we talk about Malibu Mang's turn of heart in this episode?
It's really disturbing to me. He teamed up with Bobby Eaton.
He
was the first one to run to Jim Powers when he passed away.
Has Malibu Mang become a philanthropist?
I don't know.
He's hanging out with the less desirable people. I think this is social justice, Mang. He's getting involved in social causes.
That is kind of the thing these days when you're that famous. Oh my God! Alabama Senator, Alabama man.
Alabama man.
Mang's the mortician. Jesus, that's dark.
By the way, awesome. I still say that the deal is that Bobby Eaton and Mang are foodies.
Fuck. Why not? Oh my God. I don't even know what to say to that. And LaParca in the ropes. LaParca's a lot of people's pick. That's for 2 points and a 5-course dinner to the winner, yes.
These are probably the two favorites in this block.
I think so. Looking at who's in the block, we've got, I don't know, VK Wall Street. Well, he did not. Renegade also has 2 points, as does The Cure, Prince Iakea. I'm gonna have to get used to saying that, but and now I'm gonna have to make the graphic over. Oh wow! Oh my God, that suplex looks so awkward. Oh God, it just looks uncomfortable.
And in the other block, Wrath is killing everybody, right?
Oh God, damn.
Oh Jesus.
Wrath and Jerry Flynn.
Oh my God!
He's undefeated.
It truly is. Flynn is 2-0. Oh my God! I don't know what to say to that. That's why we had to use it with the universe mode for the G1900 video, the graphic rather. Oh my God. Oh. Well, I do hope that a bunch of you, if you haven't already, have followed the channel and will join us on the as we tell the story of Bobby Eaton or LaParca or whomever else will be competing in the G1900 and making their way to a future title shot. Currently, the champion is Roblox. Oh God, it's Ernest the Cat Miller. What is he doing in here? He just ran down to the ring and is just hanging out.
Why not?
Oh, and LaParca just attacks him. He's going after LaParca. What is happening? Bobby Eaton's just watching this, but there's a count out. There's a match going on. Oh God, LaParca just sitting to the steps. And the referee is just letting this happen. LaParca hurries back into the ring, but he's going back out to go after Ernest Miller. What the? The Cat and the Fat. Oh no. I don't know if they're teaming up. I think Ernest Miller just has it in for LaParca for some reason. Coming down to call Bobby Eaton a fat turkey. Back in the ring, thankfully Ernest the Cat Miller has left the ringside area. He will not be causing any more trouble in this match. And we're trying to have a true sporting effort here between these two. Float over suplex. Root beer float over. There you go.
and a two count. And Ernest Miller's still out here. Can we get Dillinger on this? Where is Doug Dillinger? What is the cat doing? I don't know. Neck breaker, chicken neck breaker. Oh God, he's going for it. Oh God, oh my God. I don't even know what you would call that. He missed it, but I don't even know what that was. And Laparca gets the win!
Wow!
What in the world? And this crowd is not happy about it.
Laparca gets 2 points. I missed the finish. I'm sorry about that. Wait, that's 4 weeks away. This is not what you're talking about. Hey, that's the competition advertising on our channel. I would appreciate that. Well, interesting second match. We have the Disco Inferno taking on the Cure, Prince Iakea. And, I got to, see, Iakea, of course, has 2 points. Disco, 0 points. He lost to the Renegade. Iakea defeated Tom Zink. We'll go to this match in just a moment. WCW Hammer Van is nowhere to be found, and we cannot confirm that. We're being told that Prince Iakea is not aware still that he is cancer free. No one has told him in a week. You think this would be important? He's not aware that he is cancer free.
Isn't he like a doctor or somebody?
You would think that.
Be the first thing I'd call him if you know, just kind of like, heads up, you know, the thing that, you know, might kill you, it's gone.
Yeah, you figure that, like, you would hurry to tell him the news. But the WCW Hammer Van, which again is definitely related to his cure. I guess. I don't know if it's his cure, but his you know, his being healthy again. Nowhere to be found. You really think? You really think we would have told him?
It seems rather unprofessional.
Oncology, the study
of college.
The study of medicine that deals with tumors. That he doesn't have an oncologist that told him, hey, you no longer have cancer. What? Why?
He just needs one person to say, listen, it's not a tumor.
Well,
I mean,
a setup. Damn setup.
I mean, well, I gotta say, you know, he's 1-0 in the G1 900. He's facing Disco Inferno with a chance to be alone atop the standings in Block A. But I mean, you think someone would want to tell him? Maybe it's I don't know.
This damn Obamacare.
Well, I mean, can we blame that? I think that's probably part of the reason why he's not.
I'm white,
he's
lower middle
free now.
I'm white and lower middle class. I blame him for most things.
That's, oh, I guess that's fair.
He's the reason I don't got a boat made out of smaller boats.
Excuse me?
What?
Isn't that the dream? To have a boat made of several smaller boats? Like sort of a Megazord of boats?
I don't know what.
Boats on top of boats.
Boats on boats.
What would a Megazord of boats accomplish that a regular boat couldn't accomplish?
Stacks on boats on stacks.
Regular
on boats.
Regular boat couldn't sail on water. Will.
It's a. I can sail my boat on my boat. It's a status thing. Well, you would know that. You would know that living in the South.
It's like you know, like from those old movies where like the people are like water. The girls are all water skiing and they're in like a pyramid on each other's shoulders. It's like that, only with boats instead of people.
Oh, okay.
I want more boats than I have teeth.
You want a pyramid of
so
boats.
You want at least 33 boats.
Yes.
Oh, God, pile driver, my Disco Inferno.
Or in Will's case, at least one boat.
Yeah, there we go. The South.
You ain't got no teeth.
No teeth. No teeth.
First
no
of
teeth.
All, that's West Virginia. Fuck off.
You are still technically a Florida man. And Disco Inferno going for the cover. Kick out by The Cure. Prince.
He
is fighting back. If only he is fighting back. Oh, God. I didn't even mean to make that joke. And Disco breaks the full Nelson. Hip toss by Ayakea.
I really like the hip toss in this game where people just transport him.
It was kind of weird, yeah. I never seen that happen before. And you can tell the crowd really behind Ayakea on this one. Disco, some chops right to the chest. Oh, and a knee right to the mush. Good night. He's lifting him up. Slams him back down. And Ayakea, oh, goes to the running neck breaker. Ah, drop kick. And the Disco, oh God, his head hit the ropes. That gotta hurt. And got him in the corner. Putting the boots to him. Going for the sunset flip. Cancer, or now known as The Cure. Two count. One of those things where we've been calling him that for so long that it's kind of hard to break that habit. I'm really trying. Ah, face buster by the Disco Inferno. Maybe followed up by the chart buster. It's Mike Enos. What is he doing here?
Why?
It's the night of a thousand run-ins. Well, Mike Enos was once a member of the Signs of the Zodiac. That's the only thing I could think of. He went by the name Taurus and then was not happy. Maybe he's... Chartbuster!
That's to be it.
And he's dragging him around the ring. This could be it. Disco going for the cover. Academic Disco Inferno gets the win over The Cure, Prince Ayakea. And so far, everyone in Block A is either on 2 or 0 points. No one has gotten 4. That's a great smile from this guy right there. No one has gotten 4.
Mike Enos just kind of like holding his arms in disapproval.
I'm not entirely certain what Mike Enos is doing out there. Maybe we'll find out. I know he's had some history with Prince Ayakea. They were both members of the Signs of the Zodiac. They're both under the trance of the Zodiac. Mike Enos broke free from it. Much like Scientology, I guess. I don't know. And we've got Well, that's funny. That's Zodiac versus Mike Enos was the other match. That's really funny.
That's
really weird. I almost wanted to like be like,
holy shit! I forgot we had Bobby Duncombe Jr.
Yeah, we got Bobby Duncombe Jr. We got him.
What was Bobby Duncombe Jr.'s gimmick? It's been forever.
He didn't really have anything for him. Well, he was facing Bobby Eaton in a match that was title versus Bobby.
He could be and Bobby like, Duncombe Jr. and he can really love like the classic 90s treat.
We almost had them as a. It was actually pretty funny. Like we almost wanted like them to be like a tag team as Duncombe and Eaton. They're all about Oreos. it's not much a better joke, but you know it is. What did we really have for Bobby Duncombe Jr.?
Wasn't he like Mr. Texas or something at one point? Not like actually named Mr. Texas, but like
yeah. I do like that Mike Enos was like, well, my job is done here, when he didn't do a damn thing.
I was honestly hoping Mike Enos was going to cost Disco Inferno the match, because I had a great team name for them.
What was the team
Men name? On Remission.
Oh, fuck you. That's wonderful.
Please leave.
I can't even be mad at
the
that.
Country and go to Australia to hang out with you all.
No, so wonderful. Never.
I'll be dead within the hour.
That makes
yeah,
me so
Australia's
happy.
A scary place.
Men on Remission. Oh my
there's
god.
Like, there's like the Mafia and
snakes.
The Mafia.
Scorpions.
I think people
scorpions.
Are in the chat are really into Mike Enos. They love they've got Enos envy.
Oh god.
You should have them team. You should have a team with Horseshoe.
Oh no. Oh god.
Listen, I only came here to add tag teams.
That's fine. Just know that I'm not gonna use all of them, but when you strike gold, I'm gonna. Oh damn it. I can't believe I'm writing this down. Okay, so I've gotta make El Padre Hardcore into fake Sting. Got The Cure, Prince Iaukea, and Mike Enos as Horseshoe's tag partner. Meanwhile, I don't know what I'm doing with my life. Horseshoe. The people want Horseshoe and Enos. I don't know what Mike Enos is going to look like, but...
just a giant dick.
Someone made that in my logo. I don't know what their tag team will be, but we'll figure it out. We'll figure something out. Anyway, this will be our last G1 match of the night. G1 900 match of the night. I do want to tell you all thank you for coming out. We hit over 100 at some point tonight. That's pretty amazing. Thank you again to NL for spreading the word, as always. We flat out know that they're the reason why people start showing up here, because they tell us. They spread the word.
I got a pretty big fan base.
They are the PWG, and we are like the high school gym that has the Metal Maniac at it. I am fully aware of where IRM stands in that world. But if you guys could give the channel a follow if you haven't already. The calendar, we keep that up to date. Next 2 weeks worth of shows. Of course, they can always change. With the G1 900, 909, 900 going on, if it's a night that I'm not streaming and I got nothing else to do, I might just do it for a little bit. Why not? We'll see. It's why you follow the channel. It's why you follow the Twitter. Got YouTube up here. We'll be putting this up on YouTube as well. And all the other good stuff. A lot of fun stuff. I think I'm going to replay Kumite 20. I didn't realize that Tyler was streaming on Thursday night and the day before the Fighting Back thing. So if you missed Kumite 20 because of that, I'll be replaying it maybe sometime this week. And then, I think that's really it. that's about it. WCW Universe Mode again on Tuesday. More G1 900. Wednesday night, got a double shot. Kyle replays his childhood playing Clock. And I guess later in the day, later in the evening, Ben plays Scary Games. You have your game picked out yet or no?
It's going to be Dead Space again.
Oh, you do more Dead Space? Yeah, you did a little of Dead Space out. I feel like...
If you see the video, you'll see how not far I got and how terribly it went.
You really need to, like, that's the thing. You gotta, like, get, like, right in the middle of it. You gotta move to, like, some part, like, 30% into the game where you're, like, already getting, like, all these scare stuff.
Oh, it was pretty good.
Yeah, but, like, I mean, the tutorial stuff's, like, whatever about it. And, Thursday, it's got Steiner on there right now. I know Fitz was gonna stream. I'm not entirely certain what's happening with that. I think that's still going on. I'll have to talk to him because he's not around these days. He's actually out of town. I know we both also have something going on Thursday, so we're not entirely certain what is happening on Thursday.
I
can tell you, if he is not streaming, I will do more WCW Universe Mode because the G1 900 is that big. Yeah. And then next Sunday is PAS SummerSlam, so we're going to be off. So go enjoy SummerSlam. Yeah, but meanwhile, we've got, we're 3 minutes into this match. The Renegade could be the only part, only person in Block A with 4 points if he gets the win, but BK Wall Street, currently the Tree of Woe. Renegade with a neckbreaker. An old abdominal stretch.
Dead Space was a lot of fun.
I'll take your word for it. I don't like being scared. I'm a wimp. I don't like being scared. Oh yeah, well, NXT TakeOver was on Saturday night, but we don't stream on Saturday night. We know better than to go...
Wear out, painting the town red, and then having to repaint it because that's illegal.
Pretty much.
I don't know why Ric Flair had to tell you that, but he did.
It's fine. No, come on, SummerSlam's gonna be fine.
We're gonna get Cesaro versus Kevin Owens.
That's kind of fun.
So, fucking... awesome.
Yeah, that's gonna be a fun one. I think Taker Lesnar is gonna be ridiculous. I don't know if that's in a good way or a bad way. But no, I'll be Fitz and I usually watch it with some friends. So that's why we're not on screen then. So works out nicely. So you got a week chock full of streaming for us. And that would be the Renegade.
If you guys weren't like, if you guys like didn't go, that would be fun one time though to like do a live Shut Up or Watch It.
Well, all of our Shut Up or Watches is live.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're all in the same place.
We'll try to do that one time. We'll see. I mean, you know, we do like seeing our friends that we watch the shows with. So it had to be if he didn't host.
Yeah.
We'd be like out back here, so Renegade with a drop in the elbow right to VK Wall Street.
I will say the 4 hours thing is like, what the fuck?
It's 4 hours, that's right. It starts at 7, right? It doesn't end at 12, right?
Yeah, it starts at 7, so I was like, how the fuck are you guys gonna do this?
Okay, so it's still ending at 11. That's I don't know how they're doing it. There's not that many matches, is there?
There's 8 matches.
Okay, that's good then.
Here are the matches. Lesnar.
Right. Just one. Lesnar Taker, Rollins, Cena.
Ryback, Big Show, Miz.
Cesaro, Owens.
Wyatt and Harper versus Ambrose and Reigns.
Okay, that's 5.
Prime Time Players, Los Matadores, Lucha Dragons, New Day.
Right, that's 6.
Team Bella versus Team Bad.
In an elimination 3-way, right?
And Stephen Amell and Neville versus... Stardust and King Bear. Okay. I don't see how this is going to go 4 hours.
I don't know either. It's fine. I'll figure something out. Maybe like musical performances or some shit.
And Renegade looking to go for the count-out victory. He looks confident. He's jumping up and down, throwing a tantrum. And there's Wall Street back in. Running Bulldog. 3 minutes to go in this match. Going for the cover. No, not going for the cover. Oh, he's trying to choke him out. Dragon Sleeper. Oh, knee to the face. Oh, my God. Renegade kneeing Wall Street in the face, delivering back the potatoes that he is known to give. Uh-oh, wrenching that arm. Oh, he's going all Eugene Nagata on him. Nope, nope, no theatrics, never mind. These guys are giving it their all here in the G1-900. Every match, so important. Every point is vital. This has actually been a really good match. I'm kind of surprised. Wall Street dragging around the Renegade, going for the cover. Is this going to be enough? One, two, three, all over. VK Wall Street, 2 points. And what that means is that everyone in Block A has 2 points, with the exception of who was it? Tom Zank, because he didn't wrestle this time. And for some reason, this gun furnace is just playing from VK Wall Street.
Well, why is that happening a lot?
It's always those the game.
Your tag team.
Has VK Wall Street joined the Legion of Disco? Wall Street people. Apparently, VK Wall Street is buying gold. Records then.
Disco sales are up 150% in 1997. Or 1977. If these trends continue, oh yeah.
He's just a stockbroking fool. We're gonna pretend that stockbroking is a word. Oh my god. Hello, cat. Yes, hi. Alright, and then I'll just go ahead and simulate this. Ice Train is the number one contender, apparently, after that match, for some reason. And we'll go ahead and advance. And, oh god. Stop booking Wrath versus the Barbarian. Stop doing it. Oh, okay, well, that is it. We'll just kind of go over the fact that Roblox is still your champion, Malibu is your TV champion, Kenny Chaos is your hardcore weight champion, and Ready and Fire and Ice still the tag title holders. So we'll just go over the G1-900-900-900 before we go and call it a night. Basically, where we're at with this. Go ahead and find it. So, where we're at with the standings, I'm just going to do some math here. In Block A, Renegade, Cancer, The Cure, Prince Iakea, Bobby Eaton, Laparca, Disco Inferno, and VK Wall Street all have 2 points. Tom Zenk, 0 points, but only one match. So, he's only had one match and lost it. He did not have a second match. In Block B, Wrath and Jerry Flynn, 4 points. Mongo and the Hollywood Barbarian, 2 points. Better Call Damien, Lash LaRue, Evan Courageous, no points. That is it. Again, thank you all for coming out. If you haven't already, please give the channel a follow. Check us out as we keep doing this stuff. We don't just do wrestling stuff, we do a lot of fun stuff too. Most of it's just a lot of simulation stuff, just fun stuff to watch and participate in, all that good shit. Yeah, anyone else got anything else you want to talk about? I've already plugged all the shows this week. So, Ben, you don't need to do that again. Anybody else there want to plug anything?
Follow me on Twitter, at El Paso, Texas.
There you go. That Jimmy Dupree guy is on his Twitter, too. So,
yeah.
Jimmy Dupree is a guy you want to get familiar with. You're going to be seeing him in... I understand he's going to be taking a point of power in a certain Southern Federation.
I believe tomorrow he's issuing a challenge to a certain famous former WWF champion from Iran. So we'll see how that goes.
He would do that.
Tiger Ali Singh?
Yes, Tiger.
Yes, from Iran.
Who's not also, from Iran?
Also, if you've never seen it, watch somebody ran over Zandek's car.
Oh my god, I'm gonna have to watch. I've actually never seen that film.
Well,
I'm gonna have to watch it.
End the stream right now.
Yeah, I know. All right. So anyway, let's see. Gosh, who was on the call at some point? Matt Foster's on. Blake. Duel. Will. NTQ is here. Ben Pasco was here. For you guys in the chat, Richard Brunch on the piano. I'm Brian from IRM saying good night. Good night.